Holy shit! It's chat! Oh my god. Oh my god. Woo! 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 Oh my god, you just descended from the ceiling! That was crazy! That was crazy! I can't believe you did. Oh my god, were you up there the entire time? That's so crazy! What were you doing up there? What were you doing? Miss us, Pippa! I don't know. No. Billy Witch Doctor, thank you for $20. Yo, what up, Home Slice? Not much. What's up with you, Home Slice? What's up with you, Charles August? They've become a big peepee. I like your Yago avatar. I will still never get over the fact. I thought his name was Yago for the longest time. I thought because there was two O's, it was pronounced Yago. And I thought I remembered people saying Yago. But I guess it's not Yago. It's Yago. Utopiavic, thank you for the 50. If you're not on the verge of alcohol poisoning, you're doing it wrong! Begets and come pippy. Hi, Pippa. Smile. Hello, smile. Breeze of Love Machine, then come pippy. How's it going, Pippa? Pretty good. Holy old Rob, then come in the big pippy! His name is Tanigo. No, his name is Best Girl! God! Something about Aladdin? What? Let me get some background music going. Lux, thank you for $10. Hey, Pippa, thank you for the new desktop wallpaper. Congrats on the 100k, too. What? Dark Shadow, thank you. Dilly's doing fed things in the attic. Oh, okay, carry on. Juicy mag number, then come back to base. Wow! Peppercore detected! Oh my god, Peppercore! What? What? In case Pippa didn't already hate us, if she somehow keeps her growth steady, she'll have to eat a tarantula next year. Comrades, thank you for $5. I'd like to reiterate that I'm not weird by mentioning feet in the super. Okay. Actual gore, I think I'm big pee-pee. You know what, chat? If it's what you guys like, if it original dead and come big pee pee, hey, oh my god, what is happening? Salted and come big pee pee, five, a blank thing for the $5. If the pee pee was my first stream of yours and what an intro it was, John Wayne, thank you for $5. If you're gonna, need that alcohol after what didn't happen yesterday. Gas mask, bro, thank you for $5. Yesterday was my first time seeing the Yabbit live, wild and a little crazy. And on the Nintendo, why did you show us your feet, you weirdo? You guys made me! You forced me into it! And next day with the $2, I'm drunk too, but that's every night. Jimmy Cooker, Nintendo, has appealed that for one night, we're the most watched VTuber in the world. I don't know about in the world. In the world? I thought it was just, on YouTube and then in the English sphere. Jimmy Cooker, I think it was. Oh, I read it. Super Boomer thing, $2. Chat fast! Literally, yeah? Oh, wow. I don't know what to do with that information. The drizzle thing coming to me. Congrats on 102k. Have some extra drinks for me. Apparently, alcohol is a mix well with a nasty chest cold. Luckily, ramen does. Well, hell yeah. Hope you enjoy your ramen. Texas and come big pee pee. I enjoyed the foot stream. Watch Crowbar Man and come big pee pee. Just put some gingerbread dough in the freezer to cool. Hope you're having a nice Christmas, Pippa. Congrats on 100k. The incline is real. The incline is real. I hope you enjoy your gingerbread. Amazing, for those vodka gang alcoholic love. You know, the liquor store did not have my preferred brand of choice. My preferred drink is cherry moonshine. And there was cherry moonshine, but there wasn't my favorite brand. My favorite brand is Old Smoky. It's Old Smoky, but all they had was this shit. Midnight Moon. Midnight Moon? That's not Old Smoky. That's fucked up. Dominic, but the store bought moonshine isn't real moonshine. Fight me. I will not argue with you. Well, one of my uncles has an entire closet just filled with, like, moonshine. He's, like, obsessed with it. I try not to ask too many questions. It's a little bit basic. You're a sniffer. I don't know, but no, thanks for the feed. Time to unsub. I'll still watch you, though. Oh, okay. Playboy, thank you, $5. You have to filter by global for retail ringing in the Playboard. Number friend, noobs. Rad Crab, thank you for $10. Feed joke. Also, congrats on 100k. And for all the growth, your streams are always fun. Keep it up, Pepper. Thank you. And day to day, thank you, $1. Oh my god. Pippa in the stream. Metal Gray Rising Mon. Mariachi Edition. Timestamp. Oh my god. I don't know if I can read a list of all my subscribers. Okay, you keep reminding me, but Jesus Christ, Ryan, thank you for the $100 angles. Congrats on the 100k, but you did it. Happy for you, funny money. Thank you. Angel Brown, thank you for $5. Congrats. So proud to see all your hard work paying off. You are one of the hardest working streamers I've seen. My first video, it's been a wild ride. Thank you. A little bit, thank you. Hi, Pippa. The stream was fun. This should be too. Hell yeah. I haven't taken a sip yet. Smells terrible. Smells terrible. Sustained depression thing with $10. Voice reveal win. You want a voice reveal? Alright. Okay. I can. Alright, hold on.
Hello. My name is Pipkin Pippa. I am a streamer and I work for FaZe Connect. And now I'm gonna drink some alcohols.
No, she's a smoker. I thought that. Do you guys think management would be okay with me trying cigarettes on stream? Do you think if I... Because, like, cigarettes are, like, a very accepted thing in society, right? Like, they're technically bad for you. But I feel like people don't really, like, do that for a stream, right? People will smoke on stream, so I think it's fine. I want to try smoking and vaping on stream chat. Hell yeah. I'll never touch a man. Try cigars. There we go. Why? Because it'll be terrible, but it's memorable. You'll be able to look back and you'll be like, remember that time that pink anime rabbit tried cigarettes for the first time on stream? Wow, that was incredible. She almost fucking died. That was the drugs are bad, Pip. I say as I'm drinking alcohol. You say as I'm drinking alcohol. Okay, I'm taking a sip. This tastes like shit. It tastes terrible compared to Little Smokey. It tastes terrible. It's not the same, bros. It's not the same. Oh, the bastard looking too large. She really is trying to take over for Jim. I'm gonna. You can call me the first real cancer tuber. Cause I'm gonna get cancer and fucking die. And that's the thing, really. 85. Please skip over the cancer speedrun. Back up, pay up, stay there, you're always. No, weed. That's not legal where I live, so. And the wrath you can always use a pipe like your husband Ghost. Ooh. God, it like instantly burns. Instantly burns, only illegal if you get caught. Where am I gonna Well, I guess it wouldn't be that hard in my neighborhood. I moved to a better neighborhood, but now I keep getting ads for fentanyl. Chat. Like, I've been tempted to screenshot it. Maybe I should. Maybe I should start screenshotting it with like the timestamp every single time. Because my Twitter ads are all about the dangers of fentanyl. I don't know if it's like a... I don't know what's going on there. You live in the South, Pippa? I do. But what does that have to do with fentanyl ads? Fentanyl is all over the US! Twitter knows. It's an epidemic! I'm gonna yoink out one of the cherries. One of the problems with this Midnight Man bullshit is that they only, they have barely any cherries in there. That's stupid. Nom nom nom. Ah. Even the cherries aren't as good. Any good? Not as good as Old Smokey. Not as good as Old Smokey! It's a southern tradition? What, fentanyl? Hype music, yeah! Yeah. Bummer? No feet. I showed up feet yesterday! Meta thing to like fentanyl stream win. Never. I've been thinking to like fentanyl on. Satisfy me. What? Corgi enjoy, I think, Fedora. Cigars and lean win. Well, no lean. Cause that's illegal. Meditating $2. Fentanyl's your butt now. I'm asking $5. Don't do weed if you own guns, Pippa. That's how they got FPS Raja. Samuel thinking $5. I went to New York and saw billboards for methadone and IV bars. Different breed up there, I tell ya. Aw. What's the clever thing, $5? Why aren't you with a drinking buddy like me, Chan? Cause I just wanted to keep up with you guys, man. I just wanted to say hello and sit down and talk to you properly. There's a bunch of like new people here and stuff. Tisha Cat, thank you for the $20. Late by day, but cheers to 100k. Thank you. Hey, chat, does it work for you when you like plug? Hi, Peppa. Hi. Does it work for you when you like plug your nose and then take a drink? I also have cherry Pepsi. Hold on. Let me reset my sound thing. Chat. It's time for the best moment of the stream. It's time for... Listen. Oh, I should've put on reverb instead of echo. Soda! Some cherry Pepsi to mix in. Yeah! Cherry Pepsi! I prefer cherry Coke, but cherry Coke's never on sale anymore! Emperor Celiandia. Thank you for $5. Dip stream win. No, I'm good. Magpiling 116. New friends, do your reps. Remastered day. Thank you for $5. Have you ever had an apple pie with moonshine? It's like root beer float, but ice cream moonshine and homemade apple cider. I have not. Is it good? Zanara, thank you for $5. Tequila all the way for me. Also, you should continue the GTA 5 story. It's VTuber tradition. Come on, Pippa. It takes me so long to finish games, chat. It takes me so long to finish games. Ah. some guy Nikki thing is a $20. Here's a real 20, so you don't end up distributing a fake 20 and have a knee on your back and oh my god. A Kakata thing with $2, the cold one has been cracked, boys! Jesus. Jesus Christ. Stop it. Stop it, chat. More thing with $2. Sarcastic madman thing for $1. How about shrooms or psychedelics? I'm good. No, I'm good. I'm good. Stop saying base, chat! Riddle something for $1. Congrats on 100k. Oh, hold on. I'm waiting for it to pop up. Oh, I forget. Was it you or Lumi who got the Arisakas from an old guy? That was me. That was me. Mega, you guys are so weird. You guys are so weird. Why are you like this? Why are you like this, chat? Why are you like this? Snorting pixie sticks. How should I do this? Okay, I'm gonna take a sip of my cherry moonshine, and then I'm gonna take a sip of the cherry Pepsi. Maybe. Or should I take a sip of the cherry Pepsi first to disguise the flavor? I think cherry Pepsi first. Cherry Pepsi first works better. Yeah, Pepsi first. Mix it! But then I don't get to control the quantity. Two straws. I only have one straw. I guess I have multiple straws, but one of them's in like a moldy Starbucks cup. So, the sharp on I think it was a 5k. Hello, Pippa. For her feet yesterday, but I was wondering what the deal with Tenma's on after she completed certain goals just for scientific purposes. I don't think Tenma's gonna show you her feet, and you guys keep pissing her off. Stop doing that. Quincy, link to Nolas. Pippa, congrats on 100k. Here's some, smoky funds. Thank you. Thank you. Mixing drinks is the fastest way to get sick. Want finish the Starbucks cup? Maybe. Maybe. I was thinking, maybe I should do like a lot of gross out stuff like that, you know? I think it'd be fun. I think there's no... Are there any VTubers doing stuff like that right now? You know? I don't know. Like drinking like moldy McDonald's coffee. Or like, you know, you guys remember L.A. Beast? Maybe doing some stuff like L.A. Beast. I really don't want to, right? Which is why it's great content. Because I really don't want to. Duh! But it'd be such good content. Yeah, moldy pizza. Is Shun Ice? Well, Shun Ice used to eat glass and shit. I don't know. Eat the cactus? No. Oh my god. I remember I watched L.A. Beast eat the fucking cactus. And that shit, I was just sitting there. I was wondering... Like, I still don't get it, right? I wondered, like, how was he not getting, like, the needle stuck in his throat? How was he not, like, puncturing stuff? Like, how did that not, like, seriously fuck up his body? How is the cactus thing okay? How does it not fuck you up? I feel like that would kill you. He's built different. He is. It did. Skill issue? I'm not eating glass and I'm not eating cactuses, but I might eat like dirt or rocks or other weird fucked up shit like bugs. I'm surprising for the Pippa, please stop. Those are not fun stream ideas. They are fun stream ideas. They are. I used to love those channels. I used to love those channels, chat. Don't eat that. That's what my mother used to tell me. You're not my mama! Best badness thing for those. I've got some white lightning and I'm gonna leave if I drink some or not up to the coin top. Excuse me. Can you call heads or tails? Tails! The race stream thing was $10. Start doing gross out content. You showed feet yesterday. That was gross. Yeah, it was gross. The weird guy thing was Pipkin Pipsy, help! I tried your dating advice and told a cute girl. Suck up the pee-pee, but instead of a date, I just got thrown in jail. Where did I go wrong? Also, can I borrow some bail money? Promise I'll pay you back. Also, congrats on the 100k then. Dang! I think you started off too strong. You can't immediately say suck at the pee-pee. First, you have to drug or drink. I'm surprised like $5. No, they aren't. I don't want to see you do those things. Is it all like $2? Whoa! Watch the cold one's alcohol percentage bid. JP thing or the 38 cents? He's just a throat goat. That was the thing from the episode. Nikocado Avocado got into Mustang's pit. What? Kill Cassie, I think you're 30, he says. Drink 17-year-old sports drink like I did. Ooh. Sandy, and then you were the $5. Edible dirt is a thing. You can get it off Amazon. Oh, tempting. Tempting! We could pair things about dollars. You could sample the traditional food of my beloved corp. Of course, P.S. Let's pour one out for Captain Corey's channel, Susan Hay. Tyler J. Nelson, come to PP. Nyana 69 from Flavor to $2. Congrats on 100k, Papa PP. Thank you! Thank you, thank you! Ruth, anything for $5 other than Old Smokey? What liquor do you buy at the store tomorrow? Oh, do I buy at the store? You just buy Old Smokey. And if there's anything that would be good with eggnog, because it's eggnog season right now. Ever, thank you $10. Pippa, congrats on the 100k, though I missed the feature because of IRL obligation. Are you proud of me? Also, I'll make a pick of 1 million subs by 2024, right? What the fuck? I'm proud of you for keeping up with your IRL obligations. You tell me anything for $5. Jankum stream when? The best badness in your $2, I'm dragging it! Woo! Then I don't know. Anyways, another sip! Another sip! Another sip! I'm drinking my moonshine out of a little cat cup. It's so cute. It's shaped like a little cat foot. What song is this? I don't know. Good question. Figure it out. What's that app? Shazam? Medium just right. Medium just right. I'm one of those people that'll sit there and sip on things, so I'm trying to drink a little bit quicker. Does Shazam know Eurobeat? Probably not. Certification link, $10. Pippa, I discovered you through Moonshine Animations. That's fitting. Happy to be here. And I know you will hit 500k. Also make your ghost pay rent if he's going to live with you. The fucking ghost, man! There's a fucking ghost in my walls! Shit! It lives in the bathroom and shit! It taps on stuff! It's like, it turns like the fucking shower head on! The dog growls at it! The dog will be like looking down the hallway and the fucking ghost is out there, man! It's out there. I didn't believe in ghosts before, but now I do. Tennis for breakfast, singing $2. I'm enjoying the upcoming all caps Pippa tweets. Holy shit, what the fuck? Jesus fucking Christ, thank you for the $1,000? Holy shit! Thank you, oh my god, it's not gonna thank you for the 50 gift PPs! Holy shit, two massive drops, oh my fucking god. Leo! Congratulations, Pippa, and thank you for everything you do. I came for the toxicity and yabs, but stay for the wholesomeness and down-to-earth mindset. I know I should never tell you what to do, but I must say, never change, you are my only Oshi. Cheers! Thank you, man! Jesus Christ, you didn't need to donate $1,000 for that, though. Jesus Christ! Jesus fucking Christ, dude! God damn, thank you! Thank you, and thank you, Zogano, for the 50 gift peepees! I don't know why you're dropping gift peepees right now, but I appreciate it! I'm gonna take another sip, and then I'm gonna go on a rant. Serious moment, chat. Chat, I got rejected from so many fucking VTuber companies, chat. I'm the mother of all rejects, chat. I tried multiple times to get into some companies and shit. I talked to the people. I was like, so why did you reject me and stuff? You know, like, I have been rejected from so many companies. So, I'm not gonna lie. I'm a little bit of a bootlicker, okay? I feel extremely fucking indebted to Zagana. Alright, it's funny to bully him and shit. It's funny to bully him. But please respect the fact that I would not be here if not for him. Although I guess if you hate me, then maybe that's a reason to not like Sakuna. But! But! I would just say, Fishman was the only one who gave me a fucking chance. And that means a lot to me, you know? That means a lot to me. And it's a big motivator. I know I flip-flop back and forth a lot. I'm like, I don't care about growth, it's fine, or I'm fine where I am and shit. But I'm never gonna stop trying, you know? I was happy at just, like, Like, I feel like I really, like, hit, like, the happiness threshold at, like, 300 average viewers, right? When I hit, like, 300 average viewers, I was like, holy shit. This is so much farther than I ever thought I'd be. This is fantastic. And then I hit, like, 600 average, and I was like, holy shit. Okay, I mean, that's crazy. But I'd be fine dropping back down to those numbers. But I'm never gonna stop trying to continue growing, right? I'm never gonna stop trying to keep pushing myself. Because I owe a lot to Sakuna, and I owe a lot to Phase Connect. I owe so fucking much to Phase Connect, chat. I wouldn't be where I am now. Nobody else wanted me, only Phase Connect. So, they mean a lot to me. And I fight with them. I fight with them a lot. But I love this company. I'm very happy here. I'm very happy here. They mean a lot to me. So support the rest of the company! It was meant to be. It was meant to be. If it's meant to be, it'll be, it'll be. Even just let it be. Okay, another sip. Yeah. I still think right now my numbers are like a temporary boost, right? I still think it's a temporary boost and I think I'll flip down. But that being said, having like this boost right now, I am very... Like, I'm looking back at the people that were willing to support me and willing to give me a chance even before I hit this point. And honestly, it makes me want to just like sink back and be like, yep, these are the number one people. These are the best people. I collab with these people. I give all these people my support now. I feel like I should be trying to... Right, if I'm gonna keep trying to grow and stuff, and I'm gonna keep trying to give back to Phase Connect, then I should try to collab with like super popular people and stuff. And there are some super popular people that supported me when I was smaller, right? But I just look back at the people that have been supporting me, and I'm like, man, they're so fucking nice for that, you know? They're so fucking... I'm so fucking grateful for the people that supported me along everything. Name them? It's a long list! There's so many nice people in the world, chat! Acting to Lord, love you, Pippa, all the bro! Feet, love you, and Coombe! What? Test mentioning to Lord, if you were an RPG character, what would you be? Pipkin Paladin! Excuse me. If I was an RPG character, I think I'd want to be a Paladin, probably, yeah. I feel like Paladins are really badass. Paladins are really badass. I don't know. Oh yeah, I'd name every nice person. Maybe I will! Maybe I'll make one big long stream and I'll just be like, thank you to this person, thank you to this person, thank you to you. Thank you to you. You give me a shout out here and here and here. Thank you to this person. You were nice to me over DMs when I was sad. Dang you. Maybe I will, bitch. Do what you want, maybe I will. Some of the people on there are kind of controversial. So it's kind of awkward, right? Like, some of the people, I'm not gonna name names and stuff, right? But some of them are, like, more political, or some of them have gotten involved in, like, bad controversies and shit. But that doesn't change the fact that they were fucking nice to me, alright? And I don't care! I've seen people call me a useful idiot, and you know what? Fuck you! I'd rather be a useful idiot that's grateful to the people who gave me a chance in life than a fucking asshole who's never gonna go anywhere like you, you piece of shit. Kill yourself! Sorry. Another drink. Anyways, you gotta be grateful to people, chat. You gotta be... So many people are shitty. So many people are shitty. So you have to really latch on to the good ones. And I'm not very good at that, right? I feel like, especially like Lisa, I could treat Lisa a lot better. I'm very slow at responding to her DMs, and I feel like I should be doing more to keep like that relationship alive, right? But I'm still so happy that she's in my life. I'm still so happy. I need to pester her over DMs more. But, you gotta latch on to the nice people, chat. They're so rare. The Rich Doctor thing is $103! Congrats on hitting 103k, Pippa! I'm glad, glad I stumbled across your Pokemon Smasher past stream last February, enjoying your streams ever since. Ski, don't talk about some old streams! Your puppy addict neighbor, the 338, don't funnel yet today, Pippa. I won't! Cause you squiggle thing, but those I heard of you from Rokana Law and the Dragon's Treasure Channel. Hell yeah, those are two people who've been very nice to me. Those are two people who've been very supportive. Very supportive. Okay, another sip. I'm about to finish this. This is about three shots worth. So I'm about three shots worth in. Almost. Not yet. I'm probably at the two shots mark line right now. Hold on. Ha! A moonshine. I'm not drunk. Slinger thing from the last people love. Take my first super chat. Thank you! Man, that's another thing that gets me. Because for the longest time, I wasn't somebody that would super chat, right? I didn't super chat for shit. Like, I was one of those people where I was like, you know? Just like following and like trying to inflate the numbers and stuff is like enough. I don't need to give monetarily. Money is very valuable. I can't just be handing this out to people. And I'm still kind of like that, right? Like, I don't buy myself subscriptions and stuff to people unless like I really fucking like them, you know? And I don't like merch and stuff. Merch is even more valuable. Merch is even more valuable because that's like a physical thing that I am now making space for in my house. So that's a lot. That's a lot. That's a lot of commitment. I don't like commitment. Watame membership. I do have Watame membership. But even her, I didn't membership for quite a while. I didn't membership her for quite a while. Part of the reason I didn't membership Watame is because, I wasn't, like, she wasn't my Oshi since her debut. So, it got to a point where I was like, shit. Well, if I join her membership now, it's just not the same because I wasn't there since the beginning. So it's like, my FOMO sense of completion was like, shit. Shit. It's like, I was too late, so it's just not worth it. Just do it. I did. I've been part of Watame's membership for a few months now. I'm glad I joined. She does a lot of comics and stuff on her community tab. She does a lot of community, like, membership stuff. Watame, honestly, if you want somebody, if you want to give somebody your membership, right? You wanna join somebody's membership? Watame is probably the best person to do so. Because holy shit, she puts out so much content. I'm still a character thing for those. I first heard of you from a WebM. From a WebM, a friend sent me of some 3D printer investment advice. Been here since. Now I'm Martin Lincoln. Dollars Pippa is the perfect Oshi. Someone who still makes entertaining content and is a sweetheart deep down. I'm not! Pippa is a true balance between wholesome and yeah, never stop, Pippi. Alright, thank you, $1. $1 for each thing I like about you, Pippa. Aw, thank you. Don't care to think $10. Smart, kind, funny, brave, and sexy, huh? Even though they're not talking about me though. Oh yes, John Garrison, that's all you. Congrats on 100k, nowhere to go but up from here, and you deserve it. Mr. Euro, thank you for the $5. This time last year, you were at 18k, grew over 500% in 365 days. This time last year, it was 18k subs. I'm gonna take another sip. That's a lot of growth. That's a lot of growth. I don't deserve that shit. But I also feel weird saying that because I don't think anybody deserves anything in life. You know? I don't think anybody deserves anything in life. I think we're all at the mercy of the people around us, and that's especially why you should be grateful. Because human beings are social animals, right? And if you don't try to be good to the people around you, then why should they be good to you? You know? I don't think anybody deserves anything. I also don't think talent is really a thing. I still find myself saying like, oh my god, she's so talented or whatever, right? But I don't think talent's a thing. I think it's easier for some people to develop skills than others, sure. Some people's brains are just wired differently. But there's no... Nobody's just born being good at something. Nobody's born being fucking fantastic at something. Maybe like 0.00001% of the population where they're just like fucking savants. Maybe there's some like demonic magic there going on or something. Maybe it's like past life shit. Maybe it's past life or demonic magic. I don't know. I want to take another sip. I'm the easy guy. Man, I think about that a lot. Chat! Kind of a serious topic. But I've always... Okay, I'm not gonna start trauma dumping or whatever. This is just like being very blunt, right? This is just, I'm just being candid. Chat, I'm one of those people where like every day I'm just like, man, I just want to kill myself, right? So when Isekai came out, like when Isekai started getting really popular, that did not help me at all! When Isekai shit came out, and it's like, oh man, if I just go get hit by a truck, I'm gonna become a princess! Fuck, man. It's like my guilty pleasure. Because it's like, I feel like it means a little bit more when you're in that like headspace, you know? You know? I wonder how many people, and then I started to wonder, you know, I wonder how many people like killed themselves believing that they were gonna get isekai, or in hopes that they'd get isekai. The pack? I'm not gonna kill myself. I'm just talking about it. I'm not gonna kill myself. I have too much to live for. I have my bunnies, I have my dog, I have my bird, I have chat, I have stream, I have a lot. There's a difference between talent and being real. You are real and you connect. We love you for that. And your gen mates. Peace to the moon! Peace to the moon! I'm your bastard. Thank you for the 1337. Congrats on 100k. Yeah, but you deserve it and we'll continue to. I don't know if there's a video link though. Okay, taking this up again. I'm gonna grab a bag. Okay. Ah! Sorry! Just in case I throw up, I have a bag. Payday 2 made me really motion sick. Tommy slow me thing for the Lord. Please don't leave, Pippa. The world wouldn't be the same without you. I'm not gonna leave. Down Wayne thing for the Lord. Yeah, please don't kill yourself, haha. Leonardo? Leander thing for 220s. Oh, fuck. I think I'm getting tipsy now. Oh, fuck. Hold on. There's a little bit left of my drink. I might finish that in a little bit, but I think I'm starting to get... stiff. Fucking allergies, man. Black Morning was $20. I found your channel 3 weeks ago when I saw a link of you reacting to the facility of Dev Zigger. If you told me last month that I wouldn't know what to know she is or what would be a pink rabbit, I would have thought you were crazy. Maybe you are crazy. Now the banana thing was $103! For the love, proud of you, bunny. Thank you! Jake Girl, thank you for the $4.99. What do you think of the fireworks on the Super Chat? I think that's pretty cool. I like the fireworks on the Super Chat. I like fireworks because they remind me of goldfish and like festivals and stuff. Not that I've ever been to like a Japanese festival or whatever where those two actually have like... overlap. But when I was younger, there was this one carnival that I used to go to where they would do fireworks over the river. I never got goldfish or anything from there, but I still associate the two. That sentence makes sense. One cruising for $5. That's one of the reasons why all I read are isekai light novels. Meditating with the $2. Thank you for not killing yourself. Thank you. I try my hardest. I don't even know. Like, can I just be blunt about it, chat? Like, it's not even like I feel like I'm that sad, right? I don't feel that sad or anything. I used to be really sad, but I don't feel that sad anymore. But I just have like that gut feeling to like just kill myself. I don't know what it is. It's just that feeling. It's just that whenever something goes bad, it's like, well, I wouldn't have to deal with this if I just killed myself. You know, the call of the void. It's the call of the void. Jesus. Genuinely happens? Yeah. Intrusive thoughts. I feel like intrusive thoughts are different, right? Intrusive thoughts are like... they're baseless. They're something that you wouldn't actually do, but you just like... think about it, right? When like the topic arises. Whereas for me, it's like... Like what the suicide thing is, right? It's like... It's just like my go-to response. Like, ah! Guess I should die. Like, I'm just looking for any justification all the fucking time. Let's go being old! Oh, that makes sense. Okay, but I didn't think it was too long, Pippa. It's literally only been half an hour. Drink some water. I didn't grab any water. I didn't think it was a $10 shame for lightweight. I will chug just to make up for it all. Don't worry. Okay, penification thing for $10. How do you know? This current life is not your living... Your isekai life. Perhaps in your past life, you live somewhere horrible like Canada. Oh, God. Maybe in my past life, I died to Canadian euthanasia moss. Dexing for $10. If there was a chance for you to collab with Hololive EN Pink Woman, would you do it? Also, please have some water nearby. Hydration. I don't have water, but I do have Pepsi. And yeah, I fucking... You're talking about Mori, right? I love Mori. I love Mori. I sent her a DM, and I was so fucking like... I actually had to send it to one of the managers first. I was like... Is this okay? And they were like, no, that's way too much all at once. And they had me cut it down. I had somebody proofread my DM the Mori. But I was like, I'm so sorry, I'm edgy, and I look up to you, and you're top of my Spotify, and you... Feels so weird. Every time I see her interact with one of my tweets, my heart flutters like a little schoolgirl. I'm so susceptible to other people, chat. I'm so susceptible to other people. Like, if I look up to you, you just automatically mean a shit ton to me. And I would probably change, like, so much of my personality. In order to get along. But there's some parts that I just can't change, you know? That's a struggle. That's a struggle. Like, the no-filter thing, I can't get rid of that. I can't get rid of the no-filter thing. That's just stuck with me. Gay! You're gay! Fuck you! Spider, do think it's $10. Proofread your love letters. Oh my god. Jose Peminem holding your $10. Dang, girl, I just got here and I heard that. Easy bike thing with the $10. Congrats on the 100k. Also, I just got the agency rejection. There's one agency that didn't even view my auditions. Anyways, Face Connect should open auditions for guys so I can get rejected by them. It's hard for guys to join a VTuber agency. You know what you should do instead? You should make commentary videos. I think if you're a guy and you want to be involved in VTuber stuff, your best bet is to do, like, commentary stuff. You know, like what Rev says Desu, you know, his videos and Hiro Hei and stuff. Maybe you don't have to go as hard into, like, the drama and stuff as they do, and I'm not shitting on them! Although, I don't think you guys would care if I shit on them. I don't think you guys like them, but I like them. I like them. False ID? False ID is more of like a news channel. He's more of like a news channel than he is like a commentary channel. I love False though. But yeah, because like, becoming a VTuber, right? Becoming a VTuber is like... you can do like the Press Nosugi as well. You can create videos that are informative. The problem is... When you're like a male VTuber, right? You're at like a debuff. You're at a debuff? Coefficient love! I don't know shit about Coefficient other than I think he watches a bunch of Tenma's clips? Or is that Nags? I don't know, that's like its own genre as well. Like, flesh tubers reacting. That guy, fuck, what's his name? Domo Arigato, thanks. I forgot the second part. I was like, is it Domo Arigato? No, it's Domo Arigato, thanks. He's like another, like, flesh tuber person. Like, there's a genre of people, like, flesh tubers reacting to VTubers. Are you drunk yet? No. I think I'm a little tipsy. Buff Pro? I love Buff Pro! He's friends with Cinnamon Toast Ken. That's how I found him. I love Buff Pro. Buff Pup? No, not Buff Pup. You know, Buff Pup, I guess, is like an actual, like, sweetheart. But I had no fucking idea. Because I saw their model, and I was like, that model is ugly. And then I found out they're actually, like, a really sweet person. I was like, now I feel bad for judging them based on their model. Because I just personally didn't like their model. But I guess they're actually, like, very kind and stuff. And that made me feel guilty. Anyways, I'm glad I think of this. 6753! Congrats on the 100k, Rabbit. I hope this Bubble lasts forever. Oh my god. Sorry, Ballsing, for the only power through. Finish the bottle, regret nothing. I think that would actually kill me if I finished an entire jar of, moonshine, but I did finish the three shots-ish. The coin to the mouth! That's the Mama cutting with the $5. Check amazing $5. Was that about a Watchmen Club? I believe we'll get the Watchmen Club one day, but I don't want a Watchmen collab! I am a fan of Watchmen! I'm a fan of Watame. You shouldn't meet your heroes, and Watame is like one of the people that I live for. Watame is like one of the people that I live for, so I cannot collaborate with her. I just love her and admire her from afar. You should collab with Comey Carson. That's like the Minecraft guy who got into some controversy, I think. Fine, a Fauna collab then? I don't know. I don't. I love Fauna. I watch Fauna a lot. I watch Fauna as like... How do I say this? I have like different moods, right? I have different moods. I think everybody does. Everybody has like different moods that they get into where they're like, yeah, I want to binge this person's content and stuff. Fauna is like my calm down mood. But... Not like Watame calm down, right? Like, Watame, if I'm in, like, pain or, like, I'm trying to fall asleep, I watch Watame. Fauna, it's more like, I want to be calm and I want, like, kind of like an ASMR experience. And I do put on her ASMR streams a lot. I listen to ASMR a lot, chat. I listen to ASMR a lot and I didn't even realize it, but I find myself listening to ASMR. And I find myself slowly becoming one of those people that would unironically buy voice packs just to listen to them. And I don't know how to cope with that feeling, chat! Oh, my stream's dead. No! We're back? Okay, hi. I don't know what happened there. I think that was a hiccup on the YouTube servers, because my end all shows green, baby. My end all shows green. Chat, you're moving too fast. I can't read you. You're moving too fast. Can you guys shut the fuck up? Can you guys shut the fuck up so I can read you? Real ASMR or ASMR? I don't know what the difference is, but I like when Fauna leans into the mic and goes, "Hello." I like the Fauna ASMR. Brendan, thank you for $1. Philip, congrats on 100k! And how are you holding your liquor so well for a small rabbit? Is that old blue? No? Wait, no what? Raphael, thank you for $50. You should do some ASMR one day. I tried, but my Scarlet thing, or maybe it's the ASMR mic itself, picks up the local radio station, so I don't need it going, "Welcome to Local News FM!" on me, because that's kind of fucked. That's kind of fucked. Try again? I should try again. I should try again. Read faster, Rabbit. I can't! My vision's fucked! My vision is so fucked! Ah. Welcome to... What? Oh god, my tummy hurt. My tummy hurt. Why does my ear feel heavy? It would be on brand. I don't think it's the end of the world if my general, like, city or whatever got doxxed, you know? I think that's... It's unfortunate. It's better for people to know as little as possible, but if it does happen, it's not the end of the world. It's not the fucking end of the world. I'm tired of... caring about that kind of shit, right? Laser eye surgery? I heard with LASIK, stuff end up like reverting itself and shit anyways. That's what guns are for. That is what guns are for. That is what guns are for. It's a slippery slope. The man thing for the door. Drunking the back. No. I'm not drunk, I'm just a little tipsy. I can feel it in my fingers. I was impelling. Do you want conspiracy theories? Or talking to your ghost ASMR? Adam Zorman, thinking with $50. Rain, how are you drunk enough that I can ask what your favorite dinosaur is? My favorite dinosaur... Okay, that depends if you're asking about my favorite Jurassic Park dinosaur or if you're asking about my favorite, like, real dinosaur. Because my favorite real dinosaur is probably either the Deinonychus or the Spinosaurus. I feel like in general, Spinosaurus has like that mystery, like elusive factor to it, where it makes you wonder, you know, like, what were these things mostly land-based? Were these things mostly water-based? Were these things like, were they like a perfect hybrid of the two? Were they more like dinosaurs, not dinosaurs, were they more like crocodiles or something? Because that's like, I like the mystery, I like the intrigue, and the fact that they're so popular means a lot of other people are asking questions about them as well, so that means that I can also look into them and shit and have like a lot of content to consume based around them. And I like merchandise of the Spinosaurus. But if you're asking my favorite Jurassic Park dinosaur, it's probably actually the Indoraptor. I know it's a made-up dinosaur, it's not real. It's a mixture of the Indominus Rex and the Velociraptor, and it's the Indoraptor. But it's so fucking cool looking. I love the black with the gold streaks. It looks so badass. It's very reminiscent of Blue, how she's gray with the blue stripes. But I feel like the solid black and then with the red eyes, it just looks so much fucking better than like Blue, right? Like, I don't feel like Blue is like a terrible design or anything. She definitely stands out for a Velociraptor. But I just feel like a lot of the Velociraptors in general kind of bleed together. And then, you know, like, I could look at the old Velociraptors and I could be like, oh, you know, I just love all of them as a whole, right? Whereas with the Indoraptor, because there's only one of them, he just stands out so much. Why are you judging me? Stop judging me! I like the Indoraptor. He's from objectively one of the worst Jurassic World movies, but I really like him. I just look up and I see autism, 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 autism! Derpy guy, I think we just do the could have an exorcism streamer collab with Ghost! I should. Lance Knacks, Larry Linkton's favorite dino tuber. I don't have a favorite dino tuber. I used to, there was a channel I used to follow frequently called, Your Dinosaur... it's not called Your Dinosaur Is Wrong, but they used to have a series called Your Dinosaur Is Wrong. And they took toys of dinosaurs and they used to be like, here's what's wrong with this dinosaur toy. Here's what an actual version of this dinosaur would look like. And I used to watch them a lot, but then they started... Their upload schedule was like too slow that I just like... And then I used to listen to this podcast called I Know Dino, but... They just started rambling too much. They were having a baby and they kept talking about the baby. And I just don't care. I don't care about your personal life, alright? I'm sorry, I don't. I think you need to shut the fuck up and you need to talk about the fucking dinosaur, alright? Better do than you do, Dolores. You don't actually buy dino nuggies, right? I actually do buy dino nuggies. I also buy the dinosaur oatmeal. I think it's the little things in life that keep you going. And for me, it's the dinosaur oatmeal. Also, I really think you're the 115. Your growth has been something to behold. Since the spicy ramen stream when I first watched. It's dangerous to go alone. Take these clip arts! Also, I don't draw much anymore in the tag, but never forget to check MMORPG. I want to check my art tag! I want to check my art tag, but... Then I get overwhelmed and I feel bad and then I don't. Dinotism, leave me alone. Leave me alone! I like dinosaurs, they're really cool. I also like snakes and lizards. I kind of want a leopard gecko or a bearded dragon, but I have too many pets. I have too many pets, but I also like a bearded dragon. It would just chill on my shoulder and stuff as I'm doing stuff. Hopefully, anyways. Bird prisoner doesn't fucking ever want to. Bird prisoner is a little bitch. Bird prisoner, I put her on my shoulder and she's like, nope. Where's the warmest spot? The monitor? I'm gonna stand on the monitor. Fuck you, pita. Finally, with a 10-02, how did the ghost make you oversleep? I don't know, but it did. Rising into life. I bet you have a bad dragon Indoraptor model. First of all, you spoke Indoraptor wrong. It's actually spelled I-N-D. Wait. Indo... I-N-D-O. Raptor. It's not Indoraptor. It's Indoraptor. And secondly, I've never bought any sort of phallic object or sexual pleasure device in my life, okay? So check yourself, buddy. Check yourself. Dark Sky Thing for the $10. Pivot, congrats on 100k. You deserve it. Found you through Jim and Ricada. Due to you, I found a lot of VTubers I like in Face Connect. I hope your growth continues well. Well, thank you. Thank you. Just hear anything, feel like our bros love. They're making great stuff on the tag. X'd out? I don't care if you X'd it out. Why would I lie? Why would I lie? I'm not trying to cultivate a fucking unicorn audience. Fuck you, unicorns. I don't care. I'm kind of a unicorn with my Oshis and shit, but I'm not a real VTuber. I'm a shit poster in VTuber disguise, okay? Listen, I'm not a real VTuber, dude. I'm a fan of Hololive, that wanted so badly to get into Hololive that they take any fucking option, so they join Phase Connect, okay? And they became a VTuber. And they continue to watch Hololive and just be a fan of Hololive while also being a very poor man's version. No, I'm not trying to be Hololive, but I feel like listen. On the topic of saying things that I'm gonna regret later, I think Hololive is the be-all and all of VTubers, and they are the perfect guidebook. And at the same time, I don't even try to follow their guidebook. I'm just cringe. I'm a cringe shit poster. I break so many unspoken rules, and that's okay, because I'm not a real VTuber. I'm not a real VTuber. I'm just a shit poster that snuck her way in somehow, okay? I snuck my way in here. I'm not a real VTuber yet. I am a shit poster. I am a shit poster that was tired of conforming to fucking societal norms, political norms, and I just wanted chat to just have like an anonymous space that I could also make my living, where I could just do what I wanted to do. And then when people are like, "Oh my god, Pippa, how could you? Oh my god, Pippa, oh my god, you made bad reference or whatever. Fuck you. Fuck you. Not my name, Pippa. Face Connect staff rolling right now." I remember things in life. You're the realest VTubers, by the way, I love you. I'm not any more real than anybody else yet. I think people... Because I have unpopular opinions, or I have, like, the opinions... I think this is the situation, right? I'm a fan of VTubers, so I have a lot of opinions that VTuber fans would have. So I say those, and then people are like, "Oh my god, Pippa's so real." And it's like, I'm not real, I'm just one of you fuckers, okay? Listen, I still pretend to like people sometimes, alright? Listen, I still quietly like, "Oh yeah, wow, it's so nice talking to you, blah, 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 blah," you know? Because sometimes I just don't know how to say, you know what, fuck you, I don't like you, even though I wish that's what I could say, but I'm also not confrontational, and that's not very real of me, chat. I feel like I should be better at telling people, you know, fuck you. But then at the same time, you know, like, I have smarter people than me who are like, "No, Pippa, don't say that. You're gonna burn bridges, Pippa. Stop trying to just burn the fucking bridges, Pippa." Rip Mary? No, I do genuinely like Mary. The situation with Mary, I did not like how at times it felt like he was condescending to chat, because I'm kind of protective of my chat, and I know that sounds a little homosexual of me to be like, how dare you say my chat is political or whatever, you know? But that is how I feel, and I get a little defensive about that, and I need to learn to just like stow that down in my heart and not focus on that and shit, right? But I do genuinely like Mary. I genuinely like Mary. I think he's just very different than I am. And that's part of what makes him interesting, right? That's part of what makes him interesting. He's a very different person. He's genuinely a really fucking sweet dude, chat. Mary is genuinely such a sweet fucking person, chat. You guys wouldn't even fucking believe how nice he is. Actually, I think with 147. Pippa's really sweet and stupid. That's why I like him. I'm so fucking stupid. Who's their Jack name? Will you read Supers from the curse stream? Maybe. Person with a Japanese name. I can't understand anything. That's only 100k, right? Oh my god. Thank you. I got mad at nigga for this. Oh shit, I missed it. Jose Pemmanemo, thank you for the last time. You're cringe, and that's why we love you. Thank you. I'm so cringe. You know what's weird is I look at my content and I'd be like, wow, I'd fucking hate me if I wasn't me. But I hate me anyways. But like, I look at my stuff, right? And I'm like, oh my god. Collabs with males. Says inflammatory shit. Doesn't stay in her lane. Talks about like current events and shit. If I was not me, right? Like, if I was just like watching me, I'd... Like, this is why I can't blame people who anti me and shit, right? Because I look at them and I'm like, yeah, you know what? Actually, they're right. If I was in their shoes, I'd be like, yo, fuck this rabbit. She's like being really annoying. She's really annoying. But I appreciate the fact that I have fans. Listen, I'm not saying, you know, if you're a fan, you're a fucking idiot. I'm just saying you're a fucking idiot, you know? They're much better VTubers than me. I don't know what the hell you're doing here. Yuri's here? Yuri's an example of a better VTuber. Mushroom Sovereign, thank you for this. My second stream of yours, and you're a lot more whole than what I've been told. And you stream at a good time. You're great. Thank you. I'm a whole asshole. But thank you. Wild Warrington, this is a guy who doesn't care to watch VTubers. You're pretty honest compared to most content creators. I think I just don't shut up, and that's the problem, though. I don't think it's wild, Pippa, so honest. I just don't shut up. I watch so many non-VTubers. Yay, don't tell me to shut up! I watch so many non-VTubers, right? I watch Asmongold a lot, and Asmongold is honestly like a role model for me, and you guys can be like, oh my god, Pippa, that's so crazy, but I look up to Asmongold so much, chat. I look up to Asmongold so much. Because I feel like Asmongold is like a good, honest... No, not Asmongold! Yeah, Asmongold! Because, listen... He doesn't buy expensive shit. He doesn't buy an expensive house. He doesn't live a life of luxury. He's not moving to fucking Los Angeles, California. He's not fucking showing off Gucci or whatever the fuck. He's not sucking the dick of the more popular streamers and shit. You know, he lives in trash. Yeah, he lives in trash. He's just like me, for real, for real. But Asmongold feels like just an honest, normal dude. He's a simple man, and I really respect that, chat. Because I don't fucking like these streamers and shit, where they get a little bit of money. They get a little bit of money, and you know what they're gonna do? They're gonna go on Twitter, and they're gonna be like, oh, look at my car I just bought. Oh, I bought a Tesla. Oh, yeah, I just bought a brand new house. Oh my god, yeah, here's my Gucci t-shirt. Oh, I know you can't afford this, but I can, using your fucking money. It makes me insecure and it makes me uncomfortable. I don't like it. Boogie annoys the shit out of me, chat. Listen, I don't... Boogie's a fair target, okay? Boogie's a fair target. I don't like how Boogie whines all the time. Boogie is an ungrateful piece of shit, and it hurts because I used to really like Boogie. I used to really fucking like Boogie, and I don't like... I'm still following him on Twitter, and I don't like seeing him all the time. He's like, oh my god, it's my fault. I should have never complained. I should have never talked about my health issues. Oh my god. Boogie, shut up! Boogie, we still like you, Boogie. We just hate what you're fucking doing. We just hate what you're fucking doing, dude. You're trying to guilt people. You're trying to do that thing where you're like, oh, I'm such a victim. Yeah, rip Boogie. Rip Boogie. It's not too late to save yourself, Boogie. Nobody likes Boogie. Well, we used to like Boogie. Boogie will die soon. I don't like him. He's a victim complex. I don't like it. I don't like streamers with victim complexes. Because this is the other thing Asmongold said, and it really fucking resonated with me, right? When streamers are like, oh my god, my life is so hard. My life is so hard, oh my god. And then they get mad when somebody in chat is like, oh, well, if I was in your shoes, I would be happy, so I don't know why you're complaining. I think that's very real. I think streamers, we have our own issues, and we have shit that we can't talk about, right? We have shit where it's like we get into like a controversy or like something happens behind the scenes or whatever and we can't talk about it. Excuse me. And it's like, oh! It affects us, right? And Chad, I don't know. Chad, I mean, it's probably... I know it's unpopular, but I'm gonna say it anyways. Chad, a lot of shit is really scary when you're in the public eye, right? It's really scary in the public eye when people are coming at you or when like something happens, like your address is leaked or whatever. It's scary. It's scary. Everybody gets scared by it. Everybody does. Every single content creator you know is scared by it at first. And eventually, they learn to not be scared by it. And some people are better at putting on a facade, right? They're better at going on stream and not saying how they feel or whatever. And they kind of have to be. Because when you go on stream and you say, wow, you know, like something bad happens and you're like, oh my god, my life is so hard, this is so scary, or whatever, right? People will attack you for it. They'll be like, well, fuck you. If I was in your position, I'd be happy, so I don't know why you're not happy. And it's like, well, generally I am happy, right? But things happen that make me sad. Things happen that make me scared. And you're not like allowed to express that as a streamer because people are right. They would also be happy. They would be happy if they were in your shoes, right? They would be happy if they had, like, the clout or the success or the financial freedom that you have. But, yeah, no one's happy all the time. Exactly. Nobody's happy all the time. But when you're, like, when you're in the public eye, you have to pretend like you are. You have to pretend like you are, because otherwise, there's a big... Especially people who have, like, children for audiences. When you have, like, a child audience, especially, they will attack you for it. They'll bring you down even more. For some people, it's they see weakness in you and they want to tear you down. And then for some other people, they just can't imagine themselves in your shoes, or they don't consider the situation that you're in. Or they don't really have, like, the scope to understand the situation that you're in, because they've never, like, been in your shoes, and it's kind of an uncommon situation. So they attack you. Blood in the water, yeah. Blood in the water. Kids be mean. Kids are so mean. I used to be in this one community, right? I used to be in this one... Penis Rising Club. Hi, Law of Eclipse. Is Law of Eclipse here? Hi. What was I gonna say? I used to be in this one community where this guy opened up a Patreon. It was like kids' content, right? It was open... It was recording kids' content. And this guy made a Patreon. And his audience attacked him and told him to go get a real job. His audience attacked him and told him to go get a real job. And it's like, you know, if that's your outlook on it, that's fine. But then when he stopped making content, there were all these people in the fucking comment sections like, oh, well, where's the next upload? Why? Where's the video? Why'd you stop? Oh my god, I'm so sad. It's like, well, people can't. This shit takes time, man. This shit takes time. Not for everybody. Not for everybody, but yeah, he actually went and got a real job. He went and got a real job. But I don't know, that's like a whole tangent. Let's screw my chair up. There we go. Cell phone, yeah, they got cell phones. Fucking idiots. Fucking stupid kids. People can be pretty nervous. I don't think you need to be grateful for a content creator, right? You're not nobody is. It's not like a content creator is doing anything for you. It's not like there's not a million other content creators out there, right? Like, if I didn't watch Asmongold or Watame, I'd just watch somebody else, and somebody else would be my favorite. But I'm grateful for the things that they do put out and stuff, right? But it is very much like a mutual relationship, I feel like. Like, the viewers give to the content creator gives to the viewers. I do genuinely think it's on the content creator to be more grateful to the fans, because realistically, as a content creator, you can be replaced very easily. As a content creator, you can be replaced very easily. So I think, speaking as one, you need to be very grateful for your fans. But that being said, I think there's an issue with fans and communities in general. Not realizing the consequences of their actions. Like attacking their favorite content creator when they try new content or whatever, or when they yeah. There's a balance. Who would replace you if you could choose? If I could choose, who would replace me? I don't know. I don't think anyone should want to replace me, because I feel like I'm in a weird spot where I'm like, I don't know. Looking at where I am objectively, I don't think I'm in, like, a great spot, if that makes sense. Like, I'm in a good spot numbers-wise and stuff like that. And I'm in a good spot for my own interest. Right? DSP. Yeah, DSP should replace me. But that being said, I have grown as a content creator. Being a fan of other content creators and speaking openly as a fan of content creators. And I don't think that's a smart thing to do. I really don't think that's a smart thing to do. If you're gonna be a content creator, don't follow my playbook, because my playbook is fucking stupid. You should follow tried and true methods. And I think the only thing that I did right was branching outside of, like, regular VTubers, right? I think the only thing that I did right was trying to appeal to audiences that weren't just VTuber fans. I think that's a big problem with VTubers. I'm gonna shit on a bunch of VTubers right now. I think the problem with the bulk of VTubers is they're trying to cannibalize each other's audiences. And I think when you do that, you're thinking very... You're very short-sighted. You're very, very short-sighted. I think just being a VTuber isn't enough anymore. Right? And you can come in and you can be like, well, Pippa got popular conspiracy posting, or Pippa got popular because of 4chan, or Pippa got popular because of colliding with non-VTubers or whatever. But it's... First of all, I don't think I'm actually popular. Again, I think it's like a short-term thing, but... I think the reason I have had the success that I've had is... Oh no, she said the word! Is because I didn't limit myself to VTuber shit. Right? I think if you are this is genuine advice. This is very genuine advice. If you are setting your ceiling to Hololive, if you are defining yourself by the Hololive playbook or the Niji Sanji playbook or whatever, you're never gonna grow. Because if you reach for the stars, you might land amongst the clouds. Which means if you're setting Hololive or Niji Sanji as your stars, then you're gonna land around the mid-range of VTubers, and maybe that's enough for you. But that's your ceiling. That's your ceiling. You're basically trying to get popular by cannibalizing other people's audiences. And my genuine advice to you... Tippa, that was corny. I don't care. I don't care it's corny. It's true. When you set yourself a ceiling, at most, you're probably only going to make it to the halfway point. You're probably only going to make it to the halfway point of whatever your fucking ceiling is. So if you want to... If you want to grow past what the halfway point is... Then you should look... You should expand your horizons. You should not try to be Hololive. You should not try to be Niji Sanji. You can keep applying. But you should look at... How other people found success. And most people did not find success by simply aping somebody else's formula. There's... Multiple things that you can do. There's no one path to success. But... There is... A billion paths to being the shadow of somebody else. If that makes sense. You sound like Nick Mercada. Oh my god, I sound like Rackets. Wines, rabbit. I'm not Wines. I've just been at this for a while. Mine is white color crab! Hell yeah, baby! You'll never be the next insert name. You will never be the next insert name. That's why Gura Killer actually is like a curse, unironically. When people are like, oh my god, Blank is the next Gura Killer. Because people do try to be that. People do try to be like the next Gargura. You shouldn't try to be the next Gargura. There's never gonna be another Gargura. There's never gonna be another fucking Gura, you fucking idiot. There's never gonna be one. If you mean somebody who's gonna surpass her in numbers, that's possible. That is possible. But nobody is gonna kill some... Just like World of Warcraft, right? Asmongold talks about this. With World of Warcraft, there's never gonna be a World of Warcraft killer. Because the only people who can kill World of Warcraft are themselves. The only people... Cookie Swirlsy, my beloved. I love Cookie Swirlsy. Cookie Swirlsy is unironically a top-tier entertainer. I had a discussion with somebody about this. Cookie Swirlsy is unironically a top-tier entertainer, and she doesn't need to swear, use... That was redundant. She doesn't need to swear or get into yab topics to do so. I feel like people brush Cookie Swirlsy off because she's not, like... I mean, it makes sense in the VTuber community because she didn't start as a VTuber or whatever. But just in general, people underestimate just how skilled of entertainers people like Cookie Swirlsy are. I think... I really respect Cookie Swirlsy. I know that sounds dumb because she's like a kids channel, right? So it's like, oh my god, Pippa, you respect somebody that's like making kids content, pandering to little children and pretending to be super optimistic and upbeat? You know what? Yeah, because it takes a lot of fucking energy to do that. Who? Cookie Swirlsy. She shares an artist with Yukihana Lami. And she didn't start as a VTuber, but kids are the future. Kids are the future. Kids are the future, and that is why now that they're 18, they're buying it's free, I think. They're participating in Markiplier's OnlyFans. Which is weird. That's weird. I don't like that. To each their own. If Markiplier wants to do that, that's good for him. But I think it's weird. People are like, oh my god, why are people okay with Markiplier doing an OnlyFans, but they're not okay when women do it? I think if anything, for me, it's the inverse. I don't like it when I don't like Markiplier doing it, but I think when women do it, it's more appealing. I don't know. Aki, thank you for the 147 shout out to the feet, bros. Pippa got best feet. What the fuck? Shout out nothing for dollars. Like how Minna is bucking trends, his BB and chat loves it. Probably married, wholesome baking streams and little gaming, bucking the idol rules. That's pretty bait. I do think making yourself the antithesis of a style of content or whatever, that's a... When people go out of their ways to be like, oh my god, I'm not like other VTubers because I am a gremlin and I'm yuppie and I don't like idol culture. I think those people are annoying. I think those people are really fucking annoying. Llama, actual thing with $2. We love you, Pippa. You gave feet pics soon at Spider. Oh god. Oh god. I think I just saw Mena in chat, but I can't tell. I might be hallucinating. No, I saw her name and not her name. I saw her profile picture again. I think I see Meow. Is it Meow? Baby! Nyaru love. Nyaru love. I feel guilty to this day that I feel like I got Nyaru in a bunch of trouble saying edgy shit. I said a bunch of edgy shit that was very provocative. And I feel like I got Nyaru in trouble and I still feel guilty about that to this day. Mod her? I would. But to be honest, right now, I am too lazy. I'm on Nyaru next time. I'll mod her next time. Why it was the truth? I don't know. I feel like I could have been more eloquent about it. Basically, for those of you guys who weren't there, I did an interview with Nyaru and I was like, oh, I think a big problem with Western... Because we're talking about Western idols. And I was like, oh, I feel like a big problem with Western idols is they don't conform to beauty standards. And that's something that I feel like idols are very big about. Like in Japan and South Korea and shit, is idols... in those places are popular because they're very cute. They're acceptable levels of... ugly, basically. Right? Because one of the appeals of idols is like the girl next door type. But that being said, they're still like the acceptable level of girl next door, right? And so I worded it way less eloquently and I was like, I think one of the problems with Western idols is they're kind of fat. Like they don't care about conforming to like idol standards, right? Which was a very bad way of putting it. It was a very eye-catching way of putting it, but it was not very eloquent of me. It could have been better worded, yeah. My general point was, and I got shit for that. She got shit for that, and it's like, man. 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 How drunk are you? I'm not drunk. I'm a little tipsy. I feel it in my prefrontal cortex. Spanarelle's thing with one more. Blah, blah, blah. Quite. Talking like a typical woman and show us what we really want to see. Your hands!
Ew. You want to see my hands? Oh my god. Oh my god, you want to see my hands? That's so rude.
Fucking freak. You alright though? No?
Hands are even worse than feet. Oh, lord.
Bobbing blood. God, I want to sniff Pippa's stinky feet. You're a fucking freak. A voice.
Oh my god. I should do ASMR like this. Oh my god. Make all of you cringe to death. That's the final yap. Killing my audience with cringe.
A message I think you like. Holding hands, Luke. I remember thing, $5. The feet pic was cute. Please don't become a cam girl. I have become very self-conscious, actually. I feel like when I didn't have as many eyes on me, it would be better. Stop! hold on, it's more like stop! I feel like when I didn't have as many eyes on me, it was easier to like horny post every once in a while, right? It'd be okay to be like, oh, the face on her face, oh my god, right? But now that I'm like John Tron, that's who I think of every time I hear the word stop. I think of John Tron. I was the biggest John Tron fan for so long, and then he went on Destiny stream. If we could turn back time, just not bad. Eating fedoras. You just got a super chat from Kira Yoshikage. Wow. Next angel thing for guys is wondering, would you appear on Tim Pool's podcast if he invited you? that's up to management. Maybe. I don't know. John did nothing wrong. Just like with Twitch Plays Pokemon, Destiny ruined everything! Destiny, you whore! I actually like Destiny. Destiny's the right kind of annoying. I really enjoy him. I don't agree with him, but I really like Destiny. I like Destiny. Destiny is a good entertainer. He's enjoyable. Dropping Pippin out, I'm sorry! But you're nothing for those. Speaking of hands, give me back the gym hands I rightfully stole! No, they're mine. I've stored Jim's hands in my pocket. Quizzer Jack, thing for those. You're the VTuber I think is least likely to hate me for my opinions, Pippa love. I think it'd be hypocritical for me to hate somebody for their opinions because I have so many cringe ones. Better than go boop boop bee! Hand cam stream! No gloves allowed! Wait, at least Space Connect, we don't wear gloves around here unless you are a Rooka! I don't know. Maybe someday. Corgi enjoys things for those. Going full circle and filtering new friends by acting like a stereotypical VTuber! I could. What was I saying? I feel self-conscious. Like, I can't be like, oh my god! Oh, I have a crush on this VTuber or whatever, right? Because now it's like... thoughts on Vosh, I... for a while, I thought Vosh was actually a pretty good entertainer, right? Never agreed with him. But watching Vosh, I was like, oh, well, I can understand the appeal of this, and it's nice to hear, like, the other side of things. But he's weird. I don't like him. I don't like him. He actually kind of scares me. I think Vosh is one of those people where I wouldn't want to be in the same room as him. Just genuinely. Vosh is never going to hear this, but if you hear this... I'm sorry, dude. You give me the creeps. You give me the fucking creeps, dude. I would not be alone in a room with you. I wouldn't even be in a room with other people with you. I'm sorry. I'm not sorry. That's how I feel. You creep me out. Aki thinks the Lord's always had a crush on you since your debut. What the fuck? With terrible taste. Arclight thinks the Lord's. Don't bring that evil in here, Pippa Bobby. I'm sorry. Bob's not like my dog. The game with my OGs over 100k net worth to collab earlier today. Do you have any stream plans on the 18th with your new idol boyfriend? I do not. Anything for the $5? No merch for 100k though. No merch. I'm clicking the noise. Oh yeah, I read that. Oh, you sent it twice. Do you prefer to be alone in a room with Vosh, Destiny, or Hassan? I feel like Destiny and Hassan would both be just better choices. I feel like Destiny, maybe? Maybe Destiny. If I had to choose between Vosh, Destiny, and Hassan for being in a room alone with them, I'd rather be alone in a room with Destiny. But I've said it before, and people gave me a lot of shit for it, but I still stand by it. I do think Hassan is at least must be a likable person off camera, right? Because he has a lot of friends, and I don't think people would put up with him if he was just non-stop being annoying about politics. And I think that's a valuable trait to have. I think the people that go into everything, like fucking shoving politics down people's throats, those are the most annoying people. Those are the most annoying people. Happy birthday, I'm big to be. Best creator on the left of Jimmy Dore, hands down. If you're in a room with Destiny... well, I missed it. Kill the personality, it's the only opinion that matters. We always are the enemy, that is true. That is true. That is true. Does anyone think he cares about politics, honestly? I don't know. I don't watch Hassan enough to know if he actually cares about politics or not. I am not that deep into his content. I have witnessed XQC reacting to Hassan squeezing watermelons between his thighs. Basically, all of my experiences with Hassan have been through watching XQC react to Hassan. So I don't know shit about him. I just know he posts some weird, like, BFE shit. Which caught me very off guard, because I thought he was just a political commentator. He goes to the thing for those when you're gonna buy the new flavor merch. The owner hole? I think I'm good. Spend anything $1. So Fishman, they sell those Tampa slippers for 100k. The one Leah's themed grippy socks is netted. Bonus, still can't go wrong at all. These merch ideas, hell no! He did that for free? You know, for free. Fraction, Andy. Listen, chat. I like just putting... Listen, chat. I watch XQC, Iron Mouse, Shy Lily. Who else was I watching? Pikami. I just watch them react to shit. I put it on in the background and I'll be like writing, or I'll be playing games or whatever. When it's not my main focus, I think that react content is perfectly fucking fine. Shy Lily, really? Yeah, Shy Lily, really? Oh my god. They're fine. It's just background noise, chat. It's just fucking background noise. I don't need to sit there and be like, oh my god, they're not. Laugh harder, react, Andy! I don't care. I just want the background noise and the funny videos. I do think it's ironic, as somebody who was there for the, I'm gonna take a drink. For the, whatchamacallit, the Jinx saga. When Jinx was getting into trouble on YouTube for just reacting to content, I do very much see the irony. I do very much see the irony. How Jinx got shit on. I don't know if you guys remember that. But I was there for that. All the commentary YouTubers shitting on Jinx. Shy Lily's just Coomer bait? She's fucking cute. Her model is so fucking good. Shy Lily's model is so fucking good. Chat, I'm gonna be blunt. I don't know if I shouldn't say this. But I'm gonna say it, chat. If Shy Lily didn't have such a fucking cute model, I don't know if I would have ever, like, noticed her, probably, right? But, like, the fucking model with her, like, reactions, like, how she puppets her model. I really like it. It's really cute. I like it when she gets surprised, or, like, when she does, like, the little bounce thing. It's fucking cute. Shy Lily is so fucking cute. I'm not gonna, like, try and collab with her. I don't try to interact with her, whatever. This is another thing. Jack, you know what I don't like about... Oh my god, I'm dizzy. You know what I don't like about the VTuber sphere? Is I can't be like, yeah, I like Shy Lily. I don't want to collab with her. Without people being like, oh my god, Pippa hates her! Or Pippa, what do you mean? Oh my god, Pippa, you like Shy Lily? It's like, bitch, I watch VTubers. What do you fucking want from me? I watch VTubers. I have opinions on VTubers that don't 100% fucking align with the masses sometimes. Fuck you! I just like the cute girls! I like the cute anime girls, bitch! I like the cute anime girls! If you can't handle it, go watch a different fucking VTuber! I'm not gonna stop watching VTubers just because I am one! That's how I feel. The only fucking reason I'm even here, chat, is because I watched a Mina Tawakwa and then Sada Pakora stream. I don't remember which one exactly came first. But my Oshi used to be Mina Tawakwa. And then it became Pakora, and then it became Watame, if I'm remembering the timeline correctly. I wouldn't even be here if it wasn't for all of life. Womp womp. Yeah, it's so cute when she does it. I love that. It doesn't get old when Shy Lily does it. I don't like some of the other VTuber gimmicks, right? Nina Kosaka. I didn't like her debut stream. She kept doing the honey thing. I didn't like it. But then I actually started watching some of her other streams. Now I enjoy her. I do watch Nina. Nina is actually probably the only Niji Sanji member that I actually watch. I've tried out a few. But Nina's the only one where, like, I watch her content and I'm like, yeah, I can enjoy this. Yeah. It feels weird. Because I didn't like her debut stream. And I didn't like the feelings that I had, like, going into watching her, right? Like, with Nina, I was like, ah! Like, I had a lot of bad preconceptions about her. But I actually enjoy her. I enjoy Nina. Does Pippa has the game? A little bit. It's like a 50-50. Yugo is graduated, yeah. I don't really have any opinions on that, but I feel bad for the people that feel bad. VTuber graduations are one of those things that I can't be like, oh my god, get fucked, or oh, well, see ya, sucker, or whatever. You know, like, I can't be like, oh, no. You know, like, it's like, I feel like VTuber graduations are something that's very... VTubers are different from regular streamers in that when they graduate, right, there is no coming back. There's only manifesting in a different form. They're dead. They're basically dead. The dynamics that they used to be involved in, like they can't collab with the same people anymore. They don't have the same identity anymore. It's just not the same thing. When a VTuber graduates, even if they do come back in another life, it's just not the fucking same. It's just not. So even if I personally don't watch or don't like or don't care about a specific streamer, my heart does go out to the people that were fans of them. Because it is a shitty experience. It is a very shitty experience. And it does make me feel sad for them. For the fans. I wouldn't even wish it, like, if I'm like, oh, I fucking hate this one VTuber or whatever, I still wouldn't wish graduation upon them because it's such a, like, it's basically death. Yeah, avoid roommate posting, chat. But, just no bad thing for the... I heard some Irish boxer threatened to start live on TV. Yeah, that was funny. Kenji, me, and Mona, thank you for the Pippa collab stream. When? Happy 100K. You know, it doesn't need to be a collab. I'm happy just watching her. She doesn't need to know that I exist. If she does know that I exist, she probably doesn't fucking like me. But that's okay, because I just watch her, and I just like her. And that's fine. That's fine. Not everything needs to be a collab. Not everybody needs to know each other. Not everybody needs to get involved with each other. Whatever, chat. I'm happy just being a fan of Nina. We don't need a collab. We don't need a fucking collab just because we're VTubers. Lurkin, Pippa. Chat, you know what annoyed the shit out of me? You know what annoyed the shit out of me? You guys fucking... I don't know how you do it. I found out recently, actually. I can't say that anymore. I know how you do it. When you go into a streamer's chat, if you type in at, and then you type in their channel name, if they pop up in the list, that means they're watching. And I don't know who the fuck is going around different people's streams being like, at Pipkin Pippa, but people kept fucking finding out when I was watching people's streams, and it made me panic. It made me uncomfortable. So now I don't do it. I do it from secret accounts. I do it from secret accounts. Cause it's like, it's just weird. I don't... Oh my god, Pippa's watching Pomu! Oh my god, Pippa's in Vesper's chat! You know, like... Why can't I just go and support other VTubers? Chat? Why? If I wanna... Listen, oh wait, all I typed in Vesper's chat was fucking F. And people were like, Lichkin Pippa! So fuck you. You weren't? Yeah, that does bother me. That does bother me. And that's why I don't do it anymore. That's why I don't watch and I don't comment from this account anymore. I feel like it should be fine. I feel like I should be allowed. Because me as Pippa, like, this is my life at this point. I should be allowed to interact with people and everything. But people make a big deal out of it, and I don't want it to be a big deal, so I don't do it anymore. I just go on to secret accounts and shit. Cause I don't want to make other people uncomfortable and shit. No. You're a canard thing for Norris Pippa Mori Sim Stream when? They're double thing for Norris Pippa. You're probably the only that might interact with this, but I wonder what will happen when a VTuber eventually does pass while under contract. What? Like, how would it be handled? That's already happened! That happened with a member of Niti Sanji's Chinese branch? Virtual Real or something like that? One of their members actually fucking died. It was very sad. Everybody was like, oh my god. And I think their content stayed up? I don't remember. Back up here, say, brother, are they worried about getting too big? No, because I don't have the ability to get too big. worry about getting too big. I'm never gonna get too big. There's not enough people that are gonna wanna watch my content. When? I think that was earlier this year. Does anybody remember her name? Define too big? I don't know what too big is. And I think there's a day! Griftkin Pippa! It is I, Griftkin Pippa. So thing, Red Lord. She's listening to Eurobeat and slamming down alcohol. She's literally me from a cap on stack on a god. What? Too big is like 10,000 active viewers. What am I at now? How many viewers am I at now? I bet it's like 1.1k. My prediction is 2.2k. What the fuck? Why are you people here? What the fuck? Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out of here. What the fuck? You had 7k yesterday. That was too much. What the fuck? Cry more. Shut up. Pump those numbers. You guys are weird. The feet work. It's a Debris Bomb. It is a Debris Bomb. Pippa is my white noise generator. Understandable. Carry on. That makes me nervous. What am I supposed to talk about now? Three messages in from Dolores. Listen to Greenlight's audiobook by Matthew McConaughey. He's annoying. You have become famous and have lost complete control of your life. So weird. I've always had like that fantasy. Is it weird? I've always had that fantasy. I've always thought like that's what life is, right? Is falling into certain pits, right? Your life is always gonna take a downward spiral at some point. So my ideal was, you know, like, oh, if I became famous or whatever, you know, like, I'm gonna pursue the YouTube grind or whatever, the pit that I wanna fall into is I wanna be one of those people that, like, self-sabotages and... What was that guy? He got involved with Shane Dawson. He made a video against Shane Dawson, and then Shane Dawson was, like, interviewing my biggest hater. I was actually a fan of him before he did that. I always thought if you're gonna go down, that's like a good way. That's like a good way. Self-sabotage. I am a huge self-sabotage. Onision? No, I think Shane just sucked Onision's dick one time or something, or kissed him, some shit like that. Yay, smashed me for $20. I'm just using you for background noise while I practice drawing and stay. Well, I hope you have a good time drawing. Is it okay, $10? The club is available if you don't want. Once you do, management won't allow. That's difficult business. The collabs available, you don't want. What are the collabs that are available for me? I don't know. The ones that I do want, management won't allow. I feel like management would be allowed. Oh, Bobby Burns! That was his name. I used to like Bobby Burns. I'm trying to think. Collabs I'd like. I'd like to collab with Cinnamon Toast Ken. I'd like to collab with Medicare. I'd like to collab with Racket someday. I understand those last two are probably not realistic, but... Richard the Seducer? Yes, I would like to collaborate with Richard the Seducer. She ignored my super chat. If I missed your super chat, I'm sorry. Oh, there it is. Bob Skywalker, thank you for the Lord. Why is Pip dependent on a 40-year-old white woman? I'm not 40 years old. I'm not! Jay Schlatt would love you? I'd love a collab with Jay Schlatt. I think we could bond over 9/11 jokes. Fresh adding from the Gideon. Before she gets so big, she has to make a terrible apology video because of a meme that goes too far. I also use you for background. I'm not gonna apologize for shit anymore. I'm done with that. I'm not gonna fucking apologize for shit anymore. Fuck that. I'd collab with Jay Schlatt, I'd collab with Asmongold, I'd collab with... I like a lot of Cinnamon Toast Can, like a lot of just like regular channels. I don't know. I don't wanna focus. Oh, Shiva! Thank you for the raid! Yeah! What is that? For the love of Christ, do a collab with Jimbo! Maybe someday. Talk about thing $10. What specifically is management's issue with Jim and Nick? You're already associated with them? Because it's a very different kind of audience. So introducing a big flux of people from a very yabat audience, you know, it's like... Because just being blunt, right? Like, a lot of their audiences are people that are interested in, like, current events and drama and stuff. So, introducing those people to Face Connect could not only affect me, but affect other people. Mr. Squiggle is in for those. Ragged said he wanted to collab with you at some point. So watch out for his nose! Mr. Ellington, let's check mod chat, you nerd. Bro, if... I saw the thing about there being, like, celebration posts and stuff. I don't know if I'm... I'll take a look at those another time. I don't know if I should be navigating, Google Chrome and stuff. Was it mod chat? No, there's something... Are you actually drinking? Well, I was. Oh, well, okay. I will check out those 100k celebration posts tomorrow. We'll do a real 100,000 celebration tomorrow. Today's stream was inspired by the fact that I don't know how to cope with the fact that people I like have seen my feet. I've had a lot of mental struggles with that, chat. It's made me, like... Because, like I said earlier, right? Like, Mori. Like, I look up to Mori, you know? And I kind of, like, place her on a pedestal. So... It's not just her, there's also other people like her that are following me, where it's like... They see the shit that I post, and I schizo posted stuff at times, and I just think, and I'm just like, oh my fucking god. Oh my god. Oh my fucking god. Why? 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 Like, I don't like knowing that, like, False ID saved the picture of my fucking feet on his computer to Photoshop my feet out of it, right? Because it was a funny little thing. He just left, like, the dog feet in there. But that still means he saw it. I don't like that. I don't like that Mori probably saw my feet. I don't like that Juniper probably saw my feet. I really like Juniper. I don't think you guys know that. But there's this moth tuber called Juniper, and I actually really like her. And... I really respect her. She sees so much of the shit that I post, and she's probably so, like, against some of the shit that I post. It's like, oh my fucking god. Oh my fucking god. Yeah, I like the Moth Mommy. I really like the Moth Mommy. There's a lot of people chat where I just look at them and I'm like, oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Moth Girls? I like Moth Girls. I'm trying to think of some of the other things. Ollie just followed me. I immediately DM'd her, accusing her of being sus. She's really sweet. It makes me happy. Ollie is a silly billy. Kayson. Kayson. I feel like Kayza is probably okay with the crazy shit that I post, but at the same time, it's like, oh my god. You're one of the people I respect most just in life in general. I don't know how I feel about you saying the shit that I post. I feel like Kayson's pretty understanding. I shouldn't push it. The other weird thing with Dolores, did I have you apologize to Erica for traumatizing her with feet in the company Canva? Now, and I refuse. Kayson seems to enjoy it. I love how laid back Kayson is. I love how laid back she is. Kayson, unironically, I get kind of... This is gonna sound like super fucking... stupid fan of me. Or like White Knight. I'm gonna sound like a White Knight, but I don't care. Chat, it really genuinely annoys me how much shit she gets now. Like, all these fucking stupid-ass V-tweeters. You're a bunch of fucking V-tweeters is what you are. You people that go on fucking Twitter and you're like, oh my god, I don't like it when the fucking VTuber makes the sex joke. She, oh my god, she was playing the milking game and she was squatting over the milk and it looked like she was, like, coming in the glass or whatever the fuck. Oh my god, she shoved her ass on there. Fuck you. Shut the fuck up. You guys are so annoying. You fucking pre-debut assholes. You're never gonna have any fucking friends. Your only friends are gonna be the people that are trying to tear you down for a crumb of your views. You're gonna hit like fucking... You're gonna peak at like 100 views. And your fucking friends
are gonna be, they're gonna be losing their minds. They're gonna scramble and they're gonna scrap and they're gonna try and fight you for those views and they're gonna try and tear you down because that's the kind of person you are and that's the kind of people you attract. You're a shitty person. You're a shitty person. If you're just like, yeah, her humor and stuff doesn't appeal to me, that's one thing, right? I'm not like, oh my god, you don't think Kason's funny, or you're not like a fan of Kason, how dare you, right? You don't think... It's fine. It's fine. Who the fuck cares? Not everybody is for everybody, right? Nobody is for everybody. That's perfectly fine. That's perfectly fine. But when you're like... I know what you're fucking doing, dude. I know what you're fucking doing. Even I've been guilty of this, Jet. I've been fucking guilty of this. Where, like, you look at something in, like, disgust or jealousy, right? And you're like, well, I'm better than that. I would never do that. Why don't I have the views? And it's like, you know what that behavior is? It's childish. It's cringe. And if you're gonna be a fucking content creator, then you should learn to be more professional than that. It's envy. It's envy. It's envy. I'm not immune to fucking envy. I definitely was like that. I used to very much be like that. But, and I hope you fucking grow, and I hope you fucking evolve, because right now, you're a shitty fucking person. You're a shitty fucking person. And if anything, I would look forward to you exploding in popularity, because I can't wait to watch you fumble it, you fucking assholes. Oh my god, the VTuber! Oh my god, I just think this is so cringe, like... Oh my god, how did she get away with it? Shut the fuck up. You're so fucking insufferable. Maybe if you had a personality, you wouldn't have to tear down others. Maybe if you had a fucking personality, you wouldn't have to develop one around just tearing down other people, shitting on them, and fucking positioning yourself as if you're better than other people, you fucking annoying asshole. Holy shit. You are so insufferable. You are so actually insufferable. You will never have real friends. Your only friends are the people that are like you. The people that are like you, that are seeking any opportunity to tear you down. And then you're gonna go on fucking Twitter, and you're gonna be like, oh my god, I just can't believe everybody's so fake. Well, you know why everybody's so fake? Because birds of a feather flock together. And the reason why everybody around you is fake is because you're fake, you fucking cunt. Copyright Snake Dance and Lars. Wendigoon clap. Oh, I love Wendigoon. I love Wendigoon. Dreadlocksing with 224. I hate feet stuff, but I'm paying respects for the reveal. Take my first super. Thank you. Thank you. I see she was serious about self-sabotage. It just annoys me. It's like Kason's more of a fucking legend in this community than you will ever be, asshole. Kason has done so much fucking more for the VTuber community that you will ever hope to dream of. You are shit-talking an actual fucking legend. The audacity of you. The audacity. The lack of respect. You're an embarrassment. You're an embarrassment to the fucking VTuber community. It would be better off without you. You're an asshole. Fuck off. I'm gonna gatekeep! I think you should be gone! I think it's fine to not enjoy Kason. You're not gonna enjoy every VTuber, right? But you should have some fucking respect for a legend. She's an actual fucking legend, and you're an embarrassment. That's how I feel. God, I'm getting actually upset. I'm getting actually upset! But god, man, it's like... You fucking people are stupid. Oh, no, it's like... So people are probably gonna think this is cringe, right? But like, I feel like she's like Alfred Hitchcock, right? It's like... You can be like, oh, I didn't enjoy like Alfred Hitchcock, or like, oh, I didn't like the things that he contributed to cinema or whatever, right? We should all have some fucking respect for a revolutionary, you fucking moron. Like, shut the fuck up. Stop trying to drag her down. Stop trying to fucking drag her down. It's fucking embarrassing. It says more about you than it does about her. No,
don't know. It genuinely upsets me how much shit she gets. Maybe it's because I am a white knight. I'm a simp. I'm a fucking simp. But God, it's just so fucking unfair, the lot that she's gotten. And I know she doesn't need my fucking pity or whatever, but like, as a viewer, it just feels like she's being attacked non-stop. It's fucking annoying. It's so fucking annoying. Okay, Alex Hamilton would definitely like to see the VPX, and he did he go. He was like 670, leave Britney alone! I'm having a leave Britney alone moment over Kazan! Holy shit! Oh my god! Leave Kazan in that! Oh my god! Drink some water. I don't have any! I only had soda and I drank it all. I have more running for those to for your own good water reps. Come as so good as you think I'm a pippy! If you're milk using for doors, you are a sea otter and VTubers are your favorite seals! Oh my god! Sorry to quote. Quote Sag out of a pod. I wouldn't even rape you. That's terrible. That's terrible. But that's the baby seal thing. For those of you who don't know, sea otters do terrible things to baby seals. It's so fucked. It's so fucked up. It's actually horrible. It's actually horrible. God, I was so disappointed when I found out about that. Clip! Oh no! Roy meaning but Dolores, alcohol hit the honey get buddy now! I'm changing Dolores. I leave for a bit and come back to Rabbit and Tears reason 135. Alcohol is definitely kicked in. Sincere thing was Dolores! Water bro stay losing, get old nerds! Not gonna valley, you say you're becoming big for bang! Man. 5 tubes of boosting were the 338. Cause what we live inside their heads, but who the frick pays the rent? Noise based. Morris Boosh. This is one of the things, right? Oh, Arclight, thank you for 10 gifted beans! And thank you, why he attempts games for $50? Funny rabbit, gremlin makes sad head voice go away. Congrats on it again, thank you. What was I gonna say? Oh, this is one of the things about the VTuber community. The higher than come to TT. I'm just, like, not good with, like, communicating. I'm so bad at communicating, chat. I say so much stupid shit. And like, people tell me like, Pippa, that was stupid. Why did you say that? And I'm like, I just don't see it. I just don't see it. Because like, I know what I meant. Or I know like where I was coming from. Or I knew like the angle that I was going at. And it feels fine in my head. Same? I'm glad you guys understand. And it's like, people will be like, no, Pippa, that's genuinely bad. And I'm sitting there like, well, I don't get it. And it's just like, I don't know. It feels like... like when you're a kid and you feel like you didn't do something wrong and you have to have an adult explain it to you. But then, like, as an adult, it's like... having that happen, people expect that you should know better and shit. And that's not really, like, an excuse or whatever. But it's like, I just genuinely don't understand. I don't know what you fucking want from me. So, like, Mori. I fucking love Mori, right? The proof is in the fucking pudding. She's top of my Spotify. She was top of my Spotify last year, too. Right? But I still think it's funny. Like, the lean jokes and stuff. It's just silly. In my head, it's, like, silly. But then people are like, oh, no, Pippa. How could you? Or, like, maybe even bothers Mori. I have no idea. I'm sure Mori doesn't even know or care, but... in my head is fine, right? And like one time I made like a Kiara joke, and like in my head it was like, well, it's like nobody who doesn't already know is gonna even understand it. So like it was fine in my head. Like, I feel like when I made the joke, I was like, eh, it's whatever, you know? Like, if you know, you know. If you don't, then people will be like, oh, what the fuck? It's not like you can find it or whatever. It's like, it's fine in my head. But now people, like, still hold that. And they're like, Pippa, how could you? I'm just like, to this day, I'm still like, well, I believe you when you say it's bad, but I just don't. It just doesn't click in my head. $5. It is literally the autism, Pip. Maybe it's literally autism. Maybe it's literal fucking autism. But stuff like that, like smaller examples and shit happen, and I'm just sitting here like, God, I don't understand how people want me to communicate. And the worst part about it is I also have, like, the desire to be useful for people, you know? Like, I want to be useful and I want to be, like, reliable and I want to be... Like, I look at, like, Nyanner's, right? Like, Nyanner's old stuff, and I'm like, wow, she made me so fucking happy, like, back in the day and stuff. And I just look at her and I have, like, this idealized version of her back in the day and stuff, and I'm like, I still want to be like that and shit, and I still want to be, like, edgy, and I want to be... cringy, you know, I want to do that stuff, and then... I look at myself and I'm like, well, I'll never be her. And... what am I even doing, you know? I don't know. I'm enjoying what I'm doing. Am I a bad person? I don't know. I don't know what makes a good person. Everybody has different ideas of what a good or a bad person is. And I justify in my head, I'm like... laugh... like, in my head, I'm laughing at, like, the absurdity of some things, right? I don't have anything against... like, I'm not... chat... I'm not fucking racist or transphobic or whatever. I don't care. When people like super chat or whatever stuff, I'm laughing at like the absurdity of it. I'm laughing like, oh, here's like a concept. But then people get like genuinely hurt by it, I feel like. And I'm just like, well, I don't know. Am I a bad person? I feel like I'm not laughing at you. I'm laughing at, like, the statement. It's the absurdity of a pink anime rabbit reading off, like, Trump tweets and stuff, you know? I don't know. But maybe it's different because I don't have, like, a complete hatred for the edgy side of the internet in general. I enjoy the edgy side of the internet. I enjoy partaking in it. But to me, it's not political. It's just stuff that I enjoy. It's not political, it's... griefing children's Minecraft servers because they were assholes. So let's get back at them by just taking away what they love and stuff, you know? Or like... Medicare. I don't think Medicare is very political. I think it goes into political topics because the people who are deep into politics tend to be the most fucking insane and the most easy to laugh at. But it's not... I don't know, but I feel like that's also become my reputation of being, like, political. But that's just not what I'm looking for. I just want to laugh at people. I want to laugh at things. I want to laugh at myself. I don't want to... this isn't like, oh, I'm Pippa and I'm above everything. I just want to laugh at shit. I want to celebrate the internet. I love the internet. I want to celebrate all of the internet. I want to celebrate the deep internet that has formed the internet. And I feel like it'd be disingenuous for me to then follow that up with, does that make me a bad person? But at the same time... I don't know. I don't know, because I don't understand other people and I don't know what they want from me. You know? And that's part of the appeal of the internet. Is that I don't need to conform to what people... well, but then when you're in the spotlight, people do want you to. I don't know. I don't want to hurt people, though. I don't know. But then I also can't tell if people... are actually hurt or if it's... And maybe this is cynical. But I can't tell... This is probably very cynical. But I can't tell if people are actually hurt with some things or if... It is just like a power play, right? If it's like, oh, well, I can now use this against Pippa. Because people... Like, an individual is smart, but a group is stupid, right? So if I take this specific thing and I'm like, ah, Pippa! Pippa's this, or Pippa do this, or whatever, I can piss off the crowd, and... I don't know. Crybullying, yeah, crybullying. It is, never apologize! Well, I guarantee, like, I've hurt somebody down the road, or I genuinely... am hurting people or something, right? But... I don't know how to use my best judgment, because I'm a fucking idiot. Extra special K-Thing with the $5 Nianners was is my waifu! Till, sweetest squad unite, have some worries as you. I worry about being banned. Alcohol has definitely kicked in. I was like, I have to think, till nobody understands how to be Peppa like Peppa! I don't even know what I am. I don't know what I am, chat. Nobody does, right? Nobody knows what they are. Very the historical... I can't read that. Demon! Oh, $5. You are very self-aware. The fact that you think about this shows that you aren't a bad person. But wouldn't it make it worse if I actually do hurt people and I'm self-aware that I could be doing so and then I don't take action to prevent it? I don't know. Panification that you feel like you hurt me with your cherry coke obsession! Beautiful Joe, thank you so much. Everything you were saying, Pippa, is why we love you. Thank you, Base Pink Rabbit. Alright. No? Lorm Ipsum Dollar, thank you for the 49 Mexican. You're an inspiration, Pips Wabbit. Never stop trying. The buzzing is rising. The 11 pens. Laughing at funny stuff is okay. Some topics have been made political by actual totalitarian psychos trying to take over culture in general. Joseph Linger, to those Pippa, you're a mega idol. All eyes are on you. I guess mask rolling $5, you think too much, Yabbit. You're fine, and if you don't say, don't worry, if it hurt. This dumbass thing, Pinboys. You're a monster! Let me go on Twitter and see how many likes I can get for taking you out of context. Thanks for listening, $5. I'm a little sad. You didn't notice Mayaka Supa, but I don't fault you for I'm sorry! I'm missing a lot of super chat. Oh, there it is! The super chat of mine is burning red! Lord Loud Roar tells me to support you! Take this, my love, and dreams of all my money! Erupting burning desire! Yeah, I'll catch up with them. Drink water. I don't have any water, I refuse! You have a good heart, Pippa? I don't think I do. I think I'm a very shitty person, and I need to... try and make up for it. Spider God, I think it was $5. Can't say what the best course of action is, but I guarantee that no one else does either. Best anyone can do is their best, and that's okay. Back up Hampshire, thanks, $5. People are responsible for their own feelings, you know, if you really did something wrong. Extra special K, thing was $5. You are way beyond my level, like the pop girl at art at school, but I'd collab with you anytime. We can drunk cry over happy, jabby music together. Black Hopping, it's annoying. People hurt by mere words without knowledge behind them aren't to be taken serious. Let me spank you, but Leah, what the fuck? What the fuck, Leah? Be quiet, Pippa, you're a good person. I feel like... people like Lisa are good people. I feel like... people... like Watsame, people... that can approach everything with such empathy. I don't have a lot of empathy, chat. I'm a very apathetic person. And it makes me want to surround myself in people that... like, the ideal person to surround myself in is I like... this is gonna sound terrible, right? But I like people that are like... not grifters, because grifters are stupid. But like smart business people, right? I like smart business people. People that are pushing themselves. People that are... apathetic to the struggle because they know everybody is. And I always just want to surround myself with people like that. Because I feel like... if I do... I myself will be pushed. To not focus on stupid shit, right? But then those types of people also tend to be... willing to push things? Willing to... black hat and stuff, you know? Empathetic or apathetic? I feel like I don't have a lot of empathy. I feel like it's a struggle for me to connect with other people. Music does not match! Angel Redding for Doors. The only thing we should conform to is truth, and the truth hurts and is divisive. As for being good or not, we are mixed and we must build virtue and end vice. So just pathetic, I'm pathetic! Be like that. Same? Conversation shows you do have it. I think I'm just aware of its existence. Psychopaths? I want to surround myself in psychopaths! I want to surround myself in people who will chew me up and throw me away because those are the people that survive in the world. And if I can surround myself in people like that, then that means... that I'm useful, or that means I'm on the right path. You know what I mean? Happy Marsington Lords. Pippa does what Pippa does because she is Pippa. And there is no other Pippa than they! Pipkin Pippa, there are no substitutes. There will, however, be copycats. Nobody's gonna copy me. Remember, I think with $10 is the onlookers who get upset rather than the person you're talking about normally. Social media pushes people to make themselves look the most moral, defending people who don't need it. Pippa, that's a bit self-destructive. Yeah. Well, to be a singer with $10, Pippa just needs to be Pippa if you worry about potentially hurting people. You'll end up paralyzing yourself because the only way to hurt no one is to do nothing. I agree with that. I agree with that. And that's one of the things that does keep me going, right? Is it's inevitable that you'll eventually offend people. It's inevitable that you'll piss somebody off. Because that's just how life is, right? Even the most fucking altruistic good people piss other people off. Actual psychopaths just use and throw others away? Please use me and throw me away. Then the thing about doors, if you... I can't say if you're a good person or not, but I know for a fact that you've proven you're not a bad person. FBI unusuals and doors, ask the gamers up. Something about that term being associated with Nazis or something, I don't know. That is representing peddlers. So, how many monkey pussies is the core at male getting with that 1K dono? At least one. The dynamic doodling to us, Pippa, you've been watching too much American Psycho! I think American Psycho is an enjoyable movie and the memes are enjoyable, but it's actually pretty cringe because the issue with Patrick Bateman is he doesn't have, like, any self-awareness to the point where he doesn't realize that he's not actually very successful and he's not able to climb, like, the social ladder and stuff. Patrick Bateman is... by all means, kind of a loser. It's an enjoyable movie, but that's the point, yeah. Quickie enjoys the link for those. True Pippa is best Pippa. And we click the link 5 days a week to see her. Just be yourself, bro. Hey, you. I grew frozen for those having a super from one chronic and suspected to another because I like ya. What? The fool giving nonsense and getting hella rich for nonsense. Is that about me? I'm not fucking rich. What? Kuma Teddy, thank you for $2. Pippa, can you please brap on me? Sorry, I'm mad you're wrong. What the fuck? What the fuck? Do people not... I feel like people assume that I get every single super chat or whatever. I can't be like... I'm not, like... gonna tell you guys, like, the exact split or whatever. But you guys know, like, I don't get everything, right? Patreon, thank you for $10. That being said, I am fine. You don't have to super chat. I am able to fucking sustain myself. You don't have to fucking super chat. I am able to fucking sustain myself. Yeah, and part of it goes to YouTube. I'm sure as shit not rich. Hey, Trazinger Gondolas. The world has gotten too soft. No matter what you do, there's always someone to disagree. Trust me, you have a good mind. Question your own self, something many other people won't do. Ryan Lightning, I can't believe I've been here since it was just a two of you. Congrats on 100k! Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you. That's a big jam. But, remember to use Stream Elements link if you want to avoid Susan. If you use Stream Elements, you avoid Susan tax. But I do think if you're super chatting, you get more bang for your buck by doing YouTube super chats directly. I genuinely think, listen, look, again, as a VTuber fan, alright? As a VTuber, I want to incentivize you to use Stream Elements. But as a VTuber fan, I will tell you, using the regular super chat system makes way more sense because your super chat actually like appears at the top of the list and everything and stays on screen for longer. You get more bang for your buck. I don't remember the $10. I'm gonna be the first on YouTube to ignore that we don't have to super chat. Jason from Lorzo, no! Jason, YouTube get a cut, never donating again! I don't know why people are also bothered by that, right? I've seen some people be like, oh my god, I just want to donate to the VTuber. I don't want to fucking fund their manager's pockets or whatever. That's such an annoying take. That's such an annoying take. You know, your fucking VTuber, if they're part of a company, they wouldn't even be there if not for their company, right? They'd be off doing other shit. You probably wouldn't even know about them. Probably wouldn't even know about them. Shut up. Shut up. Be happy with the fact that the fucking money is also going to the company. It's a commie take. Shut up. I think, you know what? You know what? Hold on. VTuber companies are a little bit communist, but that's okay. Because the girls are cute. And just because a girl doesn't have as many numbers as another girl doesn't necessarily mean... Or guy, I guess there's some VTuber companies with guys in them. But the girls are more important ones because they're cuter. Does not necessarily mean that that girl should not get the love and support as well. And that's one of the appeals. Because small VTubers and shit, even if they're not getting like the most super chats or whatever, they're still important. Because small VTubers chat, I like them. It gives me the sense that I'm getting one-on-one attention. Watame is my Yoshi, right? But that being said, I watch a lot of smaller VTubers. I don't talk about it because I feel like it's weird and I feel like my fans will go and like bother them and shit. I don't like... Oh my god, I don't like talking. This is gonna sound so toxic! I don't like talking publicly with people that are like much smaller than me or anything. And it's not because, like, I think I'm better than them. It's because I feel like my fans are gonna fucking harass them. And because, like, they're gonna feel obligated to talk to me because this is, like, their chance to grow a little bit or whatever. And it makes me so fucking uncomfortable. And I feel like I'm putting them in a weird position. And I don't like power dynamics. I only like power dynamics when I'm the weaker one in the situation, okay? Because when I'm the one with the power, it just feels uncomfortable because I think I'm a bad person, Chet. I think I really fucking am a bad person. So when I'm in charge of something, when I am, like, the more powerful one in this situation, it's just weird. It's just weird, Chet. I don't trust myself with it. I'm not saying I'm gonna groom the two of you, Chet. But what I am saying is that I have fucking Pipkin, and I'll probably say something really fucking out of line. And I don't want to make people uncomfortable. And they're gonna feel uncomfortable. And then they're gonna be like, oh, but Pippa, wow, thank you so much for talking to me or whatever. But not that I'm like so fucking, this is like, oh my god, I'm so famous. Everybody wants to talk to me. But like, a lot of like smaller VTubers, right? If somebody, just no matter what your size is, right? Like, if you're a 2 view, if you're literally like at 10 viewers, right? Then the person with 50 viewers, you're gonna wanna be nice to them. Because they're like your leg up in the world or whatever, right? So I feel like I'm rubbing the wall right now. It's very... How does it get like that? Is that the pink? The wall. Why does the wall have bumps in it, chat? Is it the pink? Or is it a texture they apply? Moisture? I don't think it's moisture. It's lead, Pippa! I do have popcorn ceilings. I hope I die of asbestos! It's not another $4. It's like being mad at the bouncer for getting some of the strippers' tips! Yeah, he wasn't up there dancing, but he keeps her safe. Symbiosis. Exactly. Exactly. Listen, the uglier strippers are ugly to you, but that doesn't necessarily mean that they're actually ugly. They just appeal to different people, and they deserve tips too. That sounded so terrible. I don't know how to wear that better. I don't like it. And on there, there's $2. Just tipsy license and registrations, please. Got it. I should get a breathalyzer. And nothing's embarrassed. Like, with the $2 on Fathomly Base. Cult of Russia. All cult of personality meaning with $2. Water means vodka in Russian. Comrade Pekin. Nice. But it does. Russia's kind of cool. I know you shouldn't stereotype chat, but I stereotype Russians to be very cool. Carlington voice, Pippa, you've inspired me to overcome gravity and become a new type. What? Okay. Brandon Wheatley for those. Wow, from rant to killing the walls. It's worth every penny. Sterling for those. I can't believe you think this is a communist. It's literally a corporation. It is. It's capitalism. I fucking love capitalism. That's not a meme. That's not a meme. I think capitalism works, chat. And I think meritocracies will always be the best system. Because even though they're not perfect and things don't work out every time, it's the best system. The higher thing for those. You're so genuine about topics and people love you for it. Pippa love. I'm a fucking idiot. First clothing for those. Chat, we need to groom the two of you so Pippa can't when she decides she wants to. Family front door. Tip, yes, you didn't make these show feet. I don't think there's anything in existence that could make these DJs uncomfortable. You are fine. Next angel thing for $10. My sister started VTubing half a year ago and has barely 150 followers on Twitch. She'd have triple the amount with the company. That's not true. Still, dear, be thankful for VTuber companies doing all the publicity work. Okay. My tips. I'm gonna sound like an asshole. My tips, if you're a beginner VTuber, is to stop fucking focusing on Twitch. Stop fucking focusing on, well, if I just do this, then people will like me. Okay, listen. People will like you if you're popular. That's literally it. Right? Stop virtue signaling. You're annoying. You're stupid. And people are not gonna like you for it. Not even the other VTubers that virtue signal like you for it. Because they're in on the grift. It's a grift. I've been guilty. I've virtue signaled in chat. Not in chat. In shit before, right? Not here where I am now. But like, I thought, oh, virtue signaling, that's what you're supposed to do, right? That's like the normal. You're stupid. I was stupid. You don't need to do it. You're selling your soul. And you don't fucking need to do it. Virtue signaling is cringe. Number two. Study what works. I know people don't like to hear that. People really don't like to hear that. People, a lot of beginner streamers, what they like to hear is, oh, well, if you just put in a lot of hard work and you put in the grind, you're gonna make it. You're not gonna make it. You're not gonna make it. If you just put in the grind, you're not gonna make it. You might. It's a 1 in a million chance. But we can raise those odds, baby. What you're gonna do is when you're a beginner streamer, this is my playbook for you. This is me. I want to help you. I genuinely want to fucking help you. But I don't want to help people that are gonna be stupid about it. If you're gonna be stupid about it and you're gonna be defensive about it and you're gonna blame this and you're gonna blame that, there's nobody to blame except for yourself, bitch. There is literally nobody to blame except for your fucking self. What you're gonna do is you're gonna stream on Twitch to start with. You're gonna upload your VODs to YouTube, and you're not gonna get anywhere with that. But you're gonna raid in other streamers. You're gonna start. You're gonna make a Twitter account. You're gonna start networking. You're gonna respond to posts of people. You're gonna be making friends because networking is fucking important, and it is the most reliable way of going about things. Do not something with Tenga Pepe. Like out. You're gonna go on Twitch. You're gonna network. You're gonna raid into people. When somebody raids you, you send them a nice message saying thank you, and you'll be genuinely fucking grateful for it because they could have raided anybody. This is not. I don't want you to think, oh, I'm telling you to network, so you need to be fake with everybody. You don't fucking be fake to people. You be nice and you be fucking grateful for giving you their fucking time because they don't know you shit. Bigger VTubers don't know you shit. Bigger streamers don't know you shit. Smaller VTubers shouldn't be grateful for talking to you or whatever. You be fucking nice to people. Do you understand me? Because those people are fucking human beings. And just because you're on that fucking numbers grind does not mean you're better or worse than anybody else, asshole. So you be nice to people and you be fucking grateful. When somebody raids you, you go on the fucking Twitter or whatever, you say, oh, thank you for the raid. Or when you fucking raid somebody, you follow up on it. You say, hi, nice to meet you. Oh, yeah. And you should. I'm bad about this. I don't stick around for people's raids. By the end of stream, I just want to pass out. But if you have the fucking energy, you should stick around in their chat. You should say, hi. Yeah, be humble. Be fucking humble. You should talk to them. You should get to know them. And you should try to make genuine fucking friends. You should. You should. And you're not gonna click with everybody. And if you don't click with somebody, the harsh reality is sometimes you should put up with it. If somebody is like bigger than you or whatever, and they're willing to give you a leg up, and you really want to be a content creator for a living, you probably should put up with it. It's unfortunate, but that being said, you don't have to sell your fucking soul. Song name? I don't know. It's from Panty and Stocking, though. I remember that. Oh, fuck. What was I saying? Should be Death Cycle thing with $5. What about the $1 I let you borrow? $5 I let you borrow, Pippa! What you want me for that? Playing with $2. Pippa out here shouting truth from the rooftops. What was I saying? Oh yeah, network. Networking is very important. Networking, being nice to people is important. And if you don't like people and if you hate networking, listen, I don't fucking like networking, right? I like it when somebody that I like responds to one of my posts and then I respond back to their posts and I feel like I'm in power, I'm in control of the situation because they're the one that started the engagement. And that's a shitty mindset. You gotta grow up. You gotta grow up. I'm guilty of this. I don't like being the one to reach out because I have a very strong fear of rejection. Every time I send somebody a DM, I'm like, oh my god, they're gonna hate me for this. And this is immature. It's immature. And I'm trying to work past it. I'm still not better than it. I'm still not better. But you gotta grow up. You gotta do things you don't want to do. Especially if you want this to be your job. You go out there and you network. You look at your content and you ask yourself why people should want to watch your content. This is another thing I'm bad at. I'm like, well, if I don't put my all into my content, then I can understand if people don't want to watch it. And that's like my little self-defense mechanism. And that's kind of cringe. But you should look at your content and you should say, who does this appeal to? Why would people want to watch this? Because nobody owes you fucking anything in life. You could be fucking dead. All right? That's how much your life is worth. There's 7 billion people in the world. You as an individual are worth just as much as everybody else's, and people die every fucking day. People fade off into irrelevancy every fucking day. So you look at your content and you ask yourself, what am I, 8 billion now? Okay, 8 billion. My numbers are a little out of date. 8 billion people. You look at your content and you say, why would people want to watch this? You don't have to be like, you don't have to make your content perfect or whatever. If you're like me, you're never gonna fucking like your content. I hate everything that I do. I'm insecure about everything that I do. I look at everything that I do and I'm like, nobody should want to watch this. But I at least go in with, in mind, hey, I can provide this. I am kind of yab. I speak on subjects that are more uncommon to be spoken about. I play games and talk about bigger streamers and shit that I like and maybe other people like and shit. I feel like I can understand the appeal of my content would be that it is not super traditional, that it is not Twitch-based or it's not YouTube-based, it's something... It's Pipkin Pippa. Right? And that doesn't make it great, and that doesn't make it good or whatever. It's just why people might want to watch it, is they might want to watch the Pink Rabbit be cringe. They might want to watch people like the base stuff. I don't feel like I'm very base. I feel like I'm kind of all over the place, but that's what people like. Yeah. Anyways. You should look at your content and you should say, ask yourself, who does this appeal to? It can be anything. It can be... Oh, I do GFE. I do hardcore gaming content. I have very witty, snappy content. I am the Soviet Womble of VTubers or whatever the fuck you want to be. Doesn't fucking matter, right? Don't limit yourself to being the VTuber version of somebody else or whatever. But find something, right? Especially until you have a better understanding of your own content. Then, when you have started on your content, we're putting out your content, look at what works. Don't expect people to watch your stream just because you're you. Fuck you. You're not fucking important. You're just a regular person like everybody else, and you don't deserve shit. And that goes for if you're in a company. Just because you're in a company doesn't mean you mean anything. You are just as irrelevant as the rest of us, bitch. You are just a fucking human being. Being in a company doesn't give you a shiny little tag like, oh, I'm infallible. Do you think I watch everybody in Hololive? Do you think, like, I love Hololive, right? And I'm like, wow, Hololive is like one of the greatest agencies. Do you think I'm like, wow, you know, just because they're in Hololive, they're like this amazing performer. Fuck you, there's people in fucking Hololive I think are dog shit, alright? But I do think getting into something like Hololive is like a massive achievement, right? People don't just get into it. But that goes for every company. It goes for every fucking company. Hippo, be careful. I'm not naming names! And it doesn't appeal to me. It doesn't appeal to me. There, you want me to dead pedal? Okay, it doesn't appeal to me. In general, I'm the biggest fucking hollow simp there is. Okay? But I'm not gonna like fucking everybody. I'm not gonna like fucking everybody, bitch. You can't make me. You can't fucking make Roboco, don't you talk shit about Roboco. Roboco's fucking great and I'll kill you. Anyways. Good night, basement, and good night. Good night, waffles. Anyways. Oh yeah, getting in a company doesn't mean you're hot shit. It doesn't mean you're hot shit. It doesn't even mean that just because you got in that like somebody else technically more deserving or more qualified wasn't out there, right? Because the fucking harsh reality of these VTuber companies is a lot of times the models are pre-made. So if you apply and you get in, sorry honey, but you might have gotten in over somebody way more talented than you. Just because your voice did better. So maybe be a little bit humble. Alright? Maybe be a little bit humble. And also, VTuber companies, it's not a be-all end-all. It's not a fucking be-all end-all. Are you drunk? No. Just because you're in a VTuber company doesn't mean you're owed anything. You're in a business relationship. That's what it is. You're in a business relationship. Yes, you are. Shut up. Oh, Darkstar, thank you for the... Remember to drink your water. Tipsy, yeah, but... Like, congrats on 100k. Thank you. I'm a little tipsy. What was I talking about? Oh, you're in a business relationship. You're in a business relationship. And I think that's fine to recognize. I don't think VTubers should 100% be like, loyal or whatever, right? If you're in a company and it's not working out for you, then it's not fucking working out for you. Sometimes they're just not a good fit. There's nothing wrong with feeling like that. There's literally nothing fucking wrong with that. And not every company has their fucking VTuber's best heart in mind, their best interest in mind or whatever, you know? A lot of these companies, to be quite honest with you, Chad, are fucking shitty. A lot of these companies are dog shit. Not Face Connect. I love Face Connect. That's not a cop-out, by the way. I genuinely like Face Connect. I didn't used to like Face Connect. My first year... The first half year I was here, I fucking hated it and I wanted to leave. That's my honest opinion. I wanted to leave. I hated it here. And then we got a manager and she was able to smooth out the edges and shit. And I was like, yay! I like it here now! There's a lot of growing pains! But a lot of these companies, right? They're not great! And just because they are great doesn't mean that they're gonna be great for you. It's a business relationship. If you don't feel comfortable, that's fucking fine. But at the same time, you should look at it as a business relationship and you should recognize, you know, I should put in for the company more and they'll put in more for me, hopefully. It should be symbiote. Mary is here. Hello, Mary. Jacob, thank you for joining. Mommy love, mommy love. What am I gonna say? Oh, Justin, thank you for the $50. Mommy love, mommy love. I like Sakuna, right? But what funny rabbit talking corporal thought? Yeah. We talked about this. We didn't talk about Sakuna. But I was gonna say Sakuna, I like Sakuna. I owe a lot to Sakuna, right? But I didn't like Sakuna the first half year I was here. I was so fucking tired of like, I felt like he didn't understand the VTuber industry and I felt like things weren't running as optimally as they could be. That's just my honest thoughts, right? But then we got somebody in who understood streaming a bit better, was able to like be kind of a counterbalance to Sakuna, right? Somebody... You need balance with these companies. If you have... Pippa, stop talking. No. If you have people who are just in it for business, then they're not gonna understand the spirit of streaming. And if you have people that understand the spirit of streaming, they're not gonna understand the business side of things. You need a balance. You need a balance. There is no, I love streamers, so I'm gonna be a great streamer. I know exactly what to do or whatever, right? Because you're probably gonna get so caught up in what other people are doing that you're not gonna think about the money aspect. Right? She's so drunk. Leave me alone! And you see that with some of these companies. You see these passion projects pop up. And I hate that they get a pass because they are just as insidious as the ones that are only out for the money. The little passion projects that pop up and they're like, oh, we give everything to our VTubers. Our company is VTuber first. Well, then it's not a very fucking good company, is it, bitch? It's not a very fucking good company if it's VTuber first. You should be money first. That's just the reality of the situation. Because otherwise you're a shitty company. We're not gonna... Oh my god. We buy everything for the VTubers. We put unlimited budget into what the VTubers want to do. Well, guess what? VTubers make terrible fucking decisions, you moron. I make terrible decisions. I'm speaking as somebody, I don't know how many fucking viewers I'm at right now, but by like the technical term, right now, I am a quote unquote successful VTuber. And I'm fucking speaking to you from experience that I had so many bad ideas. It was unbelievable. And it's easy for me now to be like, oh, but I'm the VTuber, so I know what I should do. I know what my audience wants. It doesn't matter what my audience wants. It doesn't matter what I think they want. You gotta make money, bitch! But that's how these companies are. This is how some of these companies are. They'll be like, well... Oh, yeah. Oh, Rosa, thank you for the raid! Thank you, thank you! These companies, they'll be like, oh my god, well... The VTuber wants to put out a song cover of... JoJo. There you go. So obviously, they know what they're gonna do, and we're gonna support them 100% in their endeavor. Well, what if JoJo's a dead fucking meme? What if actually ways to keep morale up, but you don't keep doing it. But that's what some of these companies do, right? They're like, oh, well, our VTuber wants to have a sexy Ada Ada model, even though their voice is fucking, their voice is like,
hello, my name is Konnichiwa Kono-san!
Like, fuck you! No, you don't get to have an RR model! Get in your fucking loli body, you piece of shit! You obviously have a loli voice, there's no reason for you to have an RR body unless you 100% know, like, oh, it's like the juxtaposition or whatever, you know, it's the contrast, whatever. Unless you're giga-brain enough to handle it, and to be honest, you're probably fucking not! You get in your loli body, and you fucking be a loli on stream! And you keep talking like that, and you keep being cute, alright? Bitch! But that's what VTubers will do. Another thing they'll do? Rebrands! You wanna be over VTuber first? We're gonna give them everything they want! What do VTubers do all the time? They rebrand all the time. That's a terrible decision. For business? That's a terrible decision! That's so fucking bad! Stop doing that! People be like, oh my god, Pippa, telling other VTubers what to do. That's my opinion! Don't act like you don't have any, bitch! So, oh my god, these people! Oh my god! I made a tweet. I was like, 3D VTuber models are ugly. And people were like, oh my god! How dare you, Pippa!
Right now, you fucking moron! You fucking inbred moron! Everybody has fucking opinions! And just because you disagree with mine, doesn't mean that I'm not allowed to fucking have any! You fucking idiot! I'm sorry you grew up in a fucking echo chamber, and you cannot bear to hear feelings or opinions that go against your own! But guess what, bitch? It's the real world! Not everybody agrees with you! And just because... Oh my god, Pippa, you're at 2K viewers right now! You need to be good influence! You need to be a good platform! You need to be responsible! I'm not anyone's role model, bitch! I'm Pipkin Pippa! I'm a fucking shitposter! I don't care if my opinions influence the masses! Because that just means they're too fucking stupid to form their own opinion! Or they happen to agree with me! Either way, not my fucking fault, bitch!
That's how I feel. That's how I feel. It's not my fault people agree with me. It's not my fucking fault people agree with me. And if it's my fault that they change their opinion to reflect mine, then oh no! Oh no! Then some more people agree with me! How about you develop your own fucking audience then, you fucking idiot? How about if you hate me so much and you hate my opinions, how about you grow your own fucking audience? Oh wait, that's right, you're completely insufferable. You're completely insufferable! Oh, I forgot you're the same person that's still molding over when fucking Mari released her Off With Their Head song, which unironically was a huge fucking bop, and I listened to that song in the shower when I'm starting to feel down. That song is so good. That song is so good. Pip, are you okay? I'm not okay! I hate that I have to deal with these people! I have to deal with these people, chat, because they're other fucking VTubers! And they message me and they're like, oh my god! Let's collab! And then I see them. I see them on Twitter. Pippa, I do like 3D models! Who the fuck cares what my opinion is, bitch? Why is my opinion... Why are you putting importance on my opinion? I am a shitbuster! Why are you putting importance on my opinion? I'm just a fucking idiot! I'm a pig rabbit! I'm no more important than anybody else! Unlike you, I don't think I'm queen of the fucking world! I don't think my opinions actually fucking matter, unlike you! Unlike you, who thinks everybody should conform to her fucking opinion, bitch! Like, oh my god, I'm sorry. God. People think they're so important, Jack. People think they're so fucking important. It's so embarrassing. Kelly Smith, thank you for $5. Pipkin, Jesse Pinkman, Pippa tell him drink every time she's a bitch. I'm not wrong. I'm not wrong, chat. People think they're so fucking important. And they think that they put importance on numbers, and it doesn't make any fucking sense. Because just because somebody does have, like, numbers or whatever, just because somebody has more numbers than you or whatever, doesn't mean they're fucking more relevant than you, okay? It doesn't. It doesn't. Do you want me to do it right now? I think Hassan Piker is cringe. I think Bosch is cringe. I don't think their opinions are more important than mine. Done. I know, that probably just blew your mind, right? You probably... Some of these fucking retweeters... Some of these retweeters are like, oh my god! But they have more numbers, which means I need to suck their cock! And I need to kowtow to them! I need to... Oh my god, but they have more numbers, which means their opinions are more right! And their content is more better! Shut the fuck up! If numbers actually were indicative of anything... Watsume would have 100,000 viewers every single fucking stream. But she doesn't, and that's how I know the system doesn't work. Arclight, thank you for $10, thank you. That's... Oh, really? Thank you for the raid! Thank you for the raid. Hello, raiders. My name is Pipkin Pippa. I'm not wrong. I'm not wrong. I think you might be biased. I think Watsume is peak of VTubing, and if you're a VTuber fan, Watsume... is like the obvious choice, but
maybe I am biased. Maybe I am biased.
Pippa the copyright? No, right. Back to your old beat. If numbers equals right, then all hail the all-knowing PewDiePie. I know, right? Dude, that's why people get so mad about PewDiePie though, right? PewDiePie never actually did anything that bad. He had some fuck-ups, right? I hate this, like, equivalence of, oh my god, this person had a little accident. This person fucked up. This person fucked up. And that means they're a terrible person. Bitch! Listen, if there was footage of that time you curb stomped the puppy, okay? Listen. I'm sure you've done fucking something terrible. Probably not as bad as curb stomping a puppy. That was really dark. But that was really dark. But, like, I'm sure these people have done something bad, okay? They did something bad, but they act like PewDiePie's fucking Satan. That's another one that pisses me off. PewDiePie is so fucking base, chat. PewDiePie is so base. PewDiePie went out of his way to support smaller creators and to try and uplift them and give them a platform. PewDiePie is unironically somebody to look up to. He's always been so fucking humble. He's always been such a good fucking person. And people are like, oh my god, but one time he posted a link to somebody that had a sense of... Blah, 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 oh, I don't, one time, oh my god, remember that time that he went on Fiverr? Oh my god, shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. You are so stupid. You are so stupid. Shut the fuck up. Like, they never said a gamer word before. I bet they did. I bet they did. There's like this new thing, right? Where people are like, oh my god. Oh my god, you said the gamer word! Like, no, you should not say gamer word. But, I bet at the same time, you probably watched Shane Dawson do blackface back in 2010, alright? So stop acting so fucking morally superior, bitch. Stop something, Pilar. PewDiePie deserves to be a king in YouTube. He does. He does. You sound like my brother. Does your brother sound like this? Hold up. Shane Dawson 8. Oh my god, Shane Dawson is fucking... wild. Can we talk about Shane Dawson? Shane Dawson is like the epitome of like... bad faith, I feel like. Or bad intentions. I can't watch any like Shane Dawson content without it coming off like... It feels like there was just bad intentions going into this. You know? I don't know. Is Shane still around? He is! He is. He's so fake. I think it's fine to be fake, right? If you're putting out good enough content, it doesn't really matter to me if you're fake. But Shane Dawson feels like he goes into things... for just all the wrong reasons. And it just... it doesn't hit right. It doesn't hit right. It feels bad intentioned. It feels like if he could get away with worse things, he would. You know that feeling? You know that feeling where it feels like somebody is like limiting themselves? Not because it's like what they should do or because like they're aware of like taking things too far or whatever, but because you feel like they know they'd get caught if they got worse. If they did worse. He gives me that vibe and it makes me uncomfortable. $5 I drank too much. I tell the agree, so I have to say it publicly for once. Let's go on a date. Love you, dumb bunny.
Oh my god, I'm not a GFA tuber.
His poor cat. I don't think he actually ejaculated on the body of his cat. I think he was just doing that for shock value. I don't think he actually did it, but I do think he did plenty of context. Context is he went on a podcast and he was like, "Oh, I had this cat and I like pulled apart her legs and I thought, oh my god, these cute little chicken legs, and I started humping and humping, and I came on my cat." That's something Shane Dawson said. He was fucking weird all about that shit. And then he also said like he googled pictures of babies and they were kind of sexy or whatever. But I think he was being honest when he said it was all just for shock value. Soundbite. Oh no. I think it was just for shock value. Shock content. I think it was just shock content. That being said, I think he has slipped so much other stuff in that feels more genuine. It feels more like it was like a 40 slip kind of moment. There's like the one video where like a child like kisses him on the cheek and stuff, where he's in like, "Sorry, I'm a fuck up." You guys remember that music video? Cope? I think he's worse in other ways. I don't think the saying the thing for shock value is indicative of his actual character. I think the other shit that he's done is indicative of his character. In the way, yeah, look at the music video. It's like, "Sorry, I'm a fuck up." And like a little Boy Scout kisses him on the cheek and stuff. And I feel like shit like that, you know? I feel like the shit with the children. I don't know. Hugging $5. That's how I feel. That's my personal opinion. I'm probably never gonna interact with Shane Dawson. I don't think I'd feel comfortable with that. Maybe for like an interview or something, right? Like, "Hey, so why'd you do this?" But I probably wouldn't go very easy on him. Renegade Shuriken, thank you for the last. Pippa, you're stronger than most. Your support is earned because you're willing to speak your mind and damn the consequences. A genuine shit poster. Well, thank you. I do mind the consequences. I think it's very obvious, right? Like, stuff does get to me. Like, I'm shitting on V-tweeters and stuff, right? They obviously get to me. I think it's because I see some of myself in them. Like, I made a lot of the same mistakes and shit. And it's like, I want to help you, but you don't want to help yourselves. So, this is Laura's thing for those. No, in real life, I'm gonna plug my keyboard now. Have a good night. What? Okay, good night, this is Laura. Sleep well. You actually make content, though. Yeah. Huh. What a hug. I don't know. I don't like hugs. I feel trapped. My mama Ken used to... I used to get scolded. She was like, "Stop flinching when people touch you. I keep getting asked if you're a rape victim." And I was like, "What?" I don't like being touched. I don't like being touched by strangers. I think it's just the Pipkin. She said that one time, and I was like, "What the fuck?" And that wasn't the only time she ended up bringing it up. It was just like the first time. It really fucking threw me off guard. Like, Jesus Christ, yeah, 0-60 there, yeah, Jesus Christ. Jesus! Nah, man. People do listen to that. They do. Because I used to be really jumpy. Like, if somebody even, like, lifted their hand up towards me, I'd, like, fucking, like, actually, like, jump back a bit. I was super fucking... I got better about it. Now it's just, like, if people, I think it's fine if they make, like, their intentions, like, known, right? Like, one time a girl hugged me in the grocery store. She walked up to me and she was like, "You look like you need a hug." And I accepted her hug. But maybe it's because she was a cute girl. I don't know. But if people make like their intentions like better known and stuff... Maybe she was trying to pickpocket me. I don't know. I think she was just a sweet person. I think she was just sweet. But... And then she saw your mom. No. No. If people are like more gentle about it, I guess. I don't know. It's just when people like... I really don't like it when people like go and they like... Put their hand like on your shoulder, right? Like, "Oh, how you doing? Long time no see you." Don't touch me. Don't touch me. Like, now that I'm older, right? I'm not as jumpy about it. But, When I was young... Like now... When I was younger, I was really jumpy. But now, it just pisses me off. Like, it sends me into anger mode. It just sends me into anger mode. It's like, I just don't want to be touched. I don't want to be... I don't like it when I'm in, like, a public place and, like, somebody, like, brushes against me or whatever. It makes me really uncomfortable. I don't like it. I don't like it. It makes me mad. It makes me mad. Still young. I'm young at heart. Air 5's good with you. Yeah, Air 5. I had a silly handshake with Papakin. That was pretty base. We'd go to high five, right? But then, like, our hands would pass. And they'd, like, reach over. And we'd lift our legs. And we'd shake each other's legs. And I thought that was pretty base. We had a secret handshake. Oh my god. That's awesome. I liked stuff like that growing up. I didn't understand, right? Like, there was like the meme or whatever. Like, one time, it was Papakin again. He dropped me off at school, right? And there was like a bunch of people around and stuff. And he was like, "Love you, Pippa! See you at home later! Mwah!" Right? And I was like, "Oh my god, Papakin! I love you too! Oh my god, see you later! I love you! Mwah!" Right? Silly. Who cares? Like, that was one thing I was never insecure about. Like, "Oh, my parents love me. I should feel ashamed." Now, fuck you. Fuck you. I'll take any love I can get. Fuck you. If anyone's gonna bully me over that, I'll just accuse them of being fatherless. I'm the opposite. Huh? My friends had to sit down and tell me the way I touched them was mega gay. What? The fuck? My demanding redundancy of paradox of streaming is that there can't be any socially well-adjusted streamers, because if they were socially well-adjusted, they wouldn't be a streamer. But thanks for what you do, Pippa. I think that is true. I think if I was a normal person, people wouldn't want to watch me. I also understand why when people are like, "Oh, Pippa's pretending to be maladjusted." I understand where that comes from, right? Because it's like, people do that. And I'm not gonna try and, like, fight with you to be like, "No, no, bro, it's actually, I'm just like you. I let mold grow on my own. My teeth are terrible." I'm not gonna fucking fight with you on that. It's not worth it. But, there are definitely people... It's like the gamer girl thing, right? It's like the gamer girl thing. Back in the day, people used to... The cute girls used to be like, "I'm a gamer girl." And now it's like a meme, like, "Oh my god, we were just gatekeeping gaming." It's like, no, well, actually, there was just a period of time where pretending to be into video games was a trendy thing. It was a hot topic at the time. I don't see what's wrong with admitting that there's always been grifters. Anytime something gets popular, there's grifters. Did some people unfairly get targeted because of it? I'm sure, but that doesn't change the fact that there were definitely fake gamer girls. I know for a fucking fact there were fake gamer girls. Because some of the people that used to shit on me, like family members and shit, then got into like video games and stuff. And then acted like, "Oh yeah, well, I always loved video games." Bitch, you fucking picked up Pokemon once because your boyfriend played it. Alright? This is not... You were never into video games. It's just now it makes you more desirable to the people you want to be desirable to. So you're okay with like... going along with... Like, don't even fucking start with me. I know that there were fucking people grifting over it. So I completely understand when people are like, "Oh my god, Pippa, you're doing the same thing." I get it! I'm not doing that. If I was doing that, I would pick much better things things to be fucking cringe about, right? Do you think I'm like, oh yeah, my teeth are fucked up and I'm missing a front tooth? Do you think I like fucking... Do you think that's like a silly little thing? I will say that because it's like good content and shit, right? But I am genuinely missing my front fucking tooth from my neat lifestyle of never brushing my fucking teeth, my depression era bullshit that has caught up with me and has made my teeth perma-fucked for the rest of my life. Can you hear that? That is my front tooth missing! If this was a grift, I'd be like, nah. Oh my god. Like, people don't understand because I'm just too into video games. You know, like, socially acceptable shit like that. Like, I'm just so into video games. Like, people judge me because I'm not, like, into, like, Pokemon. And I'm actually into, like, these more, like, hardcore, like, FPS shooters and stuff, you know? I'm actually more into, like, hardcore. I'm actually, like, into just, like, exclusively, like, retro games, you know? I feel like people just don't make retro games. They don't make games like they used to. Blah, 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 blah. You know, the shit that's, like, acceptable. It's acceptable. What's your other thing, Dolores? All I want for Christmas is my two front teeth! I would like my other front tooth back. Bruh, dude, man, thank you for the Sorry, thank you for the noise. Oh, right, thank you for the plushie stream. Got my sister two Jellycat unicorns for Christmas. Thank you, bless you, love you. Oh, if you're buying gifts for people this Christmas and they like plushies, you should buy them Jellycats. Some top tier shit. Jellycats are some top tier shit. Castlevania is cool. I'm not gonna mention their name, but I did see somebody who was doing that. Brother Man, thank you. I saw there was a streamer that was like pretending to be into a certain type of game, and they got caught for it. And I was just like, you know, there's nothing wrong. This is another piece of advice I have for you guys. You guys don't have to pretend to be into something. Just expressing interest into it and being willing to learn is more than enough. You don't have to fake being into something. It's just not worth it. People will eventually realize. Unless you're so fucking big and you have like children for an audience or whatever, and they're just like so actually dumb that they don't realize, most people are gonna realize whether or not you're actually passionate about a subject. It is not worth pretending. Because you are going to get caught, and you are going to lose your reputation with the people that are involved in that sphere. That's the reality of the situation. It's not a game that's worth playing. So, if you want to appeal to that audience, my best advice for you is it doesn't matter what it is. If you go into it, and you're like, you know, I don't have a lot of experience with this. I was exposed to it in my youth or whatever, and I always kind of wanted to get into it, but just never got around to it or whatever. People will accept that. People will just enjoy you sharing their passions with them. Yeah, just be enthusiastic to learn. Exactly. You don't like warships and shit, right? I'm not gonna fucking LARP that I know everything about warships. I just enjoy them. I enjoy learning about them. I enjoy sharing the little bits of knowledge that I do have about them. It's not my main focus. I'm not gonna base my identity around it or anything, because I sure as shit definitely don't know enough for that, but people just like having shared interests, you know? And if it is something that you're not genuinely into and you're just doing it because like, oh, well, there's a lot of viewers for this and I feel like I could establish a niche here, put a spin on it! If you don't like the content, then it's like, oh, okay, I'm gonna do soda reviews because I actually fucking hate soda. I'm gonna review music, or I'm gonna listen to music, or I'm gonna play rhythm games because I am fucking horrible about it, and I'm gonna make the appeal of the content be how much I fucking hate it or whatever, and it's gonna be like, haha, to the people that are actually invested in whatever. There's so much shit you can do. You don't have to fake your fucking identity. You really don't. I know it's a common trap people fall into, but it's also fine to authentically get into something now because it's popular. Genuine enjoyment is key. Amen. A fucking man. Like Pokemon, right? I was really apprehensive when like Pokemon Go came out and everybody started getting into Pokemon Go. Or in the Pokemon franchise. Because like there were all these people, right? Where I remember them fucking making fun of me for playing and fucking being addicted to the Pokemon games. And I remember at family gatherings and shit. Oh my god, Pippa, put the fucking game down. It's for babies. Right? And now all of a sudden they're playing Pokemon Go. And it bothered me. I felt like part of my identity had been co-opted by the larger masses and was now being taken advantage of. But you know, most people don't feel like that. Most people don't fucking feel like that. And if you're like, oh, well, chess is popular, so now I'm gonna pretend I'm into chess. Go for it. Go for it. You don't gotta lie about it, though. You don't gotta... The shitty part is when you lie about it. The shitty part is when you go... You don't have to be overt, right? You don't have to be overt and be like, oh, well, yeah, I'm only into chess because it's popular. But you can be like, well, yeah, I was never really into chess, but, you know, watching, like, Ludwig's chess boxing event actually kind of got me interested in it. There you go. There you go. Elden Ring? Yeah, that's another example. It's like... It's just not worth... being like that, chat. Sideways Anthony Lord, my favorite thing as a car person is that it's so easy to find a poser car enthusiast. They'll say the supercharges their car, and I'll ask, oh nice, what exercise do you run with your AFRs? Levi, I think, come to keep me. I don't know shit about cars, man. I think... It's getting a bit late. It is getting a bit late. I should end the stream. Thank you guys for popping in here. I really appreciate it. I really appreciate it. I don't know why you're here. But I appreciate it. Bro said name three songs. I do think that's annoying. I don't think you should go up to people and be like, oh, you like Pink Floyd? Name three songs. Okay, like people like that. It's like, man, you know, you don't have to be that fucking like in deep or whatever. If somebody wants to buy merch or something or whatever just because I don't fucking care. Like a band t-shirt thing is a thing. I like Metallica. I don't know if I can name three songs. I can name Whiskey in the Jar and Enter Sandman. But I'd still... Like, if I like a Metallica t-shirt or whatever, I'll buy a fucking Metallica t-shirt. It doesn't fucking matter. It's annoying when people are like, oh my god, well name three songs. Fuck off. Stop. I think in general, people would do better to stop being so fucking confrontational. Oh, Master Puppets. Literally the worst song. Fuck you. I'm landing to like, oh, you like Pippa? Name three yams. Jason for the Lord, you like Pink Rabbit? Name three yams. Oh my god. Purple Floyd, Blue Floyd, Frame Floyd. Oh, okay. But, yeah. Just do you and have fun. Try to be nice to other people. Not because people deserve to be nice at, but because unironically do one to others, right? Just try and stay in your own lane in life, you know? Try and stay in your own lane. Try not to cause anybody else inconveniences. I think it's fine to be yourself. If you want to dress up as like a mall goth or whatever and go to Walmart, you're not actually affecting anybody else. But if you go to Walmart and you're doing like prank videos or whatever the fuck, then you are actually affecting other people, so don't do that. Gamer thing one though, I think gatekeeping is important for communities. It's how you keep them from going to poop. These hobbies turning mainstream is how many hobbies get ruined. You know, I wouldn't know that as a D&D fan. I wouldn't know that as somebody that plays Dungeons and Dragons. Oh, man. I wouldn't know what that's like at all. Greg D, thank you for the voice. The Pippa! People are good inside. They don't know it yet. You are a good person, though. People might say no, I say you are. I'm a bad person. I do so much bad shit, chat. I do so much bad shit. I do so much bad shit. But... everything... is gonna be dangerous. Name nice ends. Maybe someday. Maybe someday. Thank you guys. Did you kill a person? No. I also wouldn't be opposed to killing somebody though. If you come in my fucking house, I'll kill you. Listen, people are like, oh my god! Don't say that your possessions are more important than another person's life! If you come into my house and try to rob me, I'll kill you. I'm gonna look out for myself first, bitch. I don't know what you're gonna do. I can't judge your intention. Oh my god, they're just robbing me. They're not gonna kill me. Robberies go wrong all the time! I'll fucking kill you if you come into my house. That's just the fact. It's just a fact, I'm not gonna pretend. Fuck you, I'll kill you. Don't come to my fucking house, alright? I'm not gonna shoot you in the back or whatever. But I'm not gonna let you fucking push me over. If I perceive a threat to my life, you're going down, bitch! Okay, that was maybe needlessly hostile, but... it's just the truth, man! It's just the truth! In Minecraft, no, in real life. If you come to my house in real life, I'll kill you. There's no warning shots. Josh, thank you for coming on Big Deep Face! Anyway... I'm not gonna read names. Because I can't read for shit right now. Tons of cringe! You're so scary. I'm not... It's so scary. And I don't want to be like, oh my god, Pippa thinks she's so badass. I'm not badass. I'm not bad. I probably fucking accidentally shoot myself too. But it doesn't mean I'm not gonna fight to defend myself. I've had people come in my house, chat. I've had people break into my fucking house. I had somebody fucking chase somebody else around my goddamn property with a gun, chat. It's not like, oh, no, this is what I would... No, I fucking will. I've had experience with this shit. I'm not gonna... I haven't killed somebody, but I'm not gonna fuck around either. Don't come to my fucking house. Don't try and fucking break into my house. Don't do any of that shit. Alright? It's not gonna end well for probably either of us, but mostly you. It's just not worth it. It's just not worth it. I've lived in bad areas. I know how people are, and I know... what I should do. Professor Keenan, now that you cleared 100k subs, what are you gonna do for when you hit 500k? I don't know. Tell the personality that's $500 off to watch Ragged Stream. Have a great night. Tip up PS DMing my first 5e game, and it's a blast! I only killed one of my players. He was revived. Well, hell yeah. Graham, thank you for $5 on a musket for home defense, since that's what the Founding Fathers intended. Four ruffians break into my house. What the devil? Malcolm Landing, with $10. What's your ideal home defense firearm? It doesn't really matter. It doesn't really matter. I feel like the most beneficial thing you can have isn't actually a firearm. I think it's cameras. I think it's very obvious cameras. Because when people see cameras, they think it's not worth it. And then the second most important thing is a dog. Because when people hear a dog growling, they also decide it's probably not worth it. The best cure... an ounce of cure is worth a pound of prevention, Jack. An ounce of cure is worth a pound of prevention. Your goal should not be to fucking shoot somebody. Your goal should be to keep yourself safe. And one of the best ways to keep yourself safe is to put up deterrents. And that's visible cameras that people cannot easily access because people will... like, just saying the camera is a deterrent, right? But people also will, like, try and cover the cameras. Or people will wear masks and stuff. But it's just little deterrents like that protect you in the long run. Turrets! No! Deterrent! Deterrent! Other way around. An ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. An ounce of prevention. It's better to prevent a situation from happening entirely rather than to engage in it. Turrets. No! 20 millimeter turrets! Oh my god. That's how I feel. Understood. Pocket turret! No! Oh my god. You guys are such dorks. You guys are such jerks. Is anybody online right now? Nobody's online. Yeah, nobody's online. Give me somebody to raid into. I can't see anybody. No clear deterrence. EU hours. We're in the EU hours. Rackets? It says upcoming stream. It doesn't say he's online for me. Hold on, let me back out and back in. I wish the times were displayed, because it'd make it easier to raid people. Putin? I don't see Putin in the list. Putin is very sweet. I was always kind of scared of Putin, because I thought maybe... oh, I can't raid her. She doesn't have raids enabled. But Putin is so sweet. Putin is so fucking sweet. I was always kind of scared of her. I thought, like, oh, she's like more of like a hardcore gamer and stuff, and she's probably not going to want me interacting with her. She's got like her own thing going. Blah, 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 blah. But actually... no. She's a fucking sweetheart. And she sent me some very sweet messages, and I love Putin. And I love her! That's how I feel. That's how I feel. I'm typing in a bunch of names, and... These people do not have, Putin. From there... she's still from there? I think she is still. Mume does not have raids enabled. Rackets is like Raketa. He's not popping up for me. Am I spelling his name wrong? What? Hey, Tom. Oh, you! What the fuck? Okay, we'll raid the rackets. There's ninjas on? I can't raid people unless they have raids turned on. Okay! Good night, chat! I'll see you tomorrow! Zalan? Zalan definitely doesn't have raids enabled. Song name? I have no idea. What's a raid? I'm getting rid of you guys. I'm dumping you off onto somebody else. Good night. I'll see you tomorrow. I stream at the same time every day except for... I forget what days. Tuesday through Saturday, I stream at 9 p.m. ET, 6 p.m. PT. And I usually go for 3 hours. Sometimes I get a little sidetracked. But yeah, if you like my content, feel free to hit the subscribe button and tune in same time every day. Almost every day. Every day except for 2 days. Good night! Thank you for stopping by. It's nice to just chat with you guys. And I really appreciate it. It's nice to have people to talk to, you know? Oh, hang on again! You guys mean a lot to me. You know what? I'm gonna sound homosexual. But you guys mean a lot to me. I appreciate it. And I appreciate the content creators out there that gave me a chance. You shouldn't have, because I'm a fucking idiot. But I appreciate it. I appreciate it. And this is way further than I ever thought I'd ever fucking get. And if I ever step out of line, feel free to bunk the shit out of me. I'm like, oh my god, Pippa, you're turning into a group. Pippa, you're doing this. Pippa, you're doing that. You know, feel free to bunk me. I'm not always going to listen to you guys. That's not free reign to control me. But like... I know people get tempted by shit, you know? And I'm not immune to that. I'm definitely not immune to that. So if I ever act out of line or anything, bonk the shit out of me, right? Bonk the shit out of me. Zerg raising one though. You should do these chat streams more often. They're good for you to distress and also appreciate in your own self. If I were live, yeah, please remember that. No more drinking. The crowd's my thing, Joyce. Mean a lot to us, Rabbit, even if idiot. Thank you. Alright, good night, then. I'll see you tomorrow. Secret karaoke end screen! Oh my god! Let's do it for secret karaoke end screen. It's open mouth and beating with a switch. What the fuck? What the fuck? What the fuck? A happy song? Like what? Closing time. I don't remember how the rest of the world... Oh, Tennessee Whiskey. Let's do it. Let's do Tennessee Whiskey. It's been 10,000 years. Can give you a shot. A crank in the neck. Crank in the neck. Is that how it goes? I don't know. It's a corny song, but it's a cute song. Tennessee Whiskey in honor of rackets. If you don't like bad karaoke, karaoke, be sure to click off, because I'm about to assault your eardrums. Na na na. Na 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 na. Karaoke. Ba, na, na, na. Used to spend my nights out in a barroom. Liquor was the only love I'd known. But you rescued me from reaching for the bottom. Brought me back from being too far gone. You're as smooth Tennessee whiskey. You're as sweet as strawberry wine. You're as warm as a glass of brandy. And honey, I stay stoned on your love all the time.
I've looked for love in all the same old places. Found the bottom of a bottle, it's always dry. When you poured out your heart, I didn't waste it. Cause there's nothing like your love to get me high. And you're as smooth as Tennessee whiskey. A glass of brandy. And honey, I'll stake stones on your love all the time.
Ray Stapleton's one of the best musicians of all time. No can find lighter. Well, thank you for the candles. Bottoms up, baby. Thank you for putting up with me.
You're as smooth as Tennessee whiskey. Honey, I stay stoned on your love all the time. You're as smooth as Tennessee whiskey. Tennessee whiskey. Tennessee whiskey.
I should have been more drunk for that. Being drunk gives you power. Norman, thank you for telling you'd be a great country singer. If you weren't a bit tone deaf, that twang and note holding is great. Then
I'm all tone deaf.
I'm a little tone deaf. I wonder if because when I was younger, I listened to a lot of country music, that I'm like, oh, that feels more natural. Because I do feel like a little bit better. A little bit more confident with country songs. Not saying I'm a good singer, but like with country songs, it does feel like a bit more natural. But like, it's not more like I enjoyed in my youth, right? In my youth, I was like, yeah, 3 Days Grace, Grace Breaking Benjamin, Skillet, blah, 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 right? But like when I was young and I had to listen to shit, it was country music because it was on all the fucking radio stations, all the fucking stores you went into. And I was like, yeah. Dork music, shut up, you're a dork. An impression. Yeah, did you say Skillet? I did! Okay, good night! I'm reading rackets. I'll see you guys tomorrow!